Good morning, good morning. It is Thursday, and you know Thursday for us is our Friday, but it is a big Thursday as we come. Good morning, my name is Percival Palmer from The Morning Connection, coming to you live from the studios of Best 100 FM, heard all over Jamaica. It's been a good week. It's been a good week for us, even though Miss Minette has not been here. She's on a sabbatical now, but she'll soon return to you. But I'm just telling you that we're here. And when we come back, we'll continue to look at issues in our nation, look at some principles out of the Word of God. So I welcome you this morning. Thank you for allowing us to come into your car, come into the bus, come into your homes as we travel throughout the length and breadth of Jamaica. Good morning. It is now 6:30 as we take our 6:30 break from The Morning Connection. I am Percival Palmer.
No, the water gone again. Yo, Dave, where did you get your water tank from? Multi-plastics tanks a lot. Oh, yeah. I heard they're selling cutting-edge water tanks. Let me find my way to 37 South Road or call them at 876-968-6657 now.
Vetran Printers for all your printing needs. We specialize in calendars, flyers, brochures, and more. Call us today at 968-7506. That's 968-7506. Or visit us at 4 East Bloomsbury Road off Haggard Park Road. Vijay Printers, your best choice in printing.
Grandpa, where are you going?
But see ya. I have business done by JPS and I need Stephen to take me. I'm going to see what I owe and pay.
You don't have to leave the yard, Pops. Just call 888-225-5577.
You mean to tell me, say, me not have to wait in line anymore?
Grandpa, I registered your account. So when you call from this phone, JPS already knows you and then just give you information.
Look where me live, Fissy. Thank God for you, young people.
What should a taxi service do for you? On-time taxi service is more than just a ride to the other side of town. They offer clean and spacious vehicles, reliable service, and promise to always look out for their customers. They'll come when you call and take you where you want to go on time.
We are something special on the road.
February is Reggae Month, and Best FM is catching the rhythm with Roots Kaleidoscope. Every week, we join the Reggae Open University from 6 to 7:30 p.m. Tune in for the latest in music. Meet the icons. Celebrate with us. Catch the rhythm on Best during Roots Kaleidoscope.
Ready, mama. Ready, ready, ready.
Is this the confusion you feel when trying to work your way through medical systems in Jamaica? Try a dose of Ask Dr. Mary every Thursday at 5 to 6 p.m. Let Dr. Mary help you understand your medical problems and bring you to a calmer place.
For a better choice in all your electrical supplies, A, authorized 3M dealer and better brand names, B, better service including free island-wide delivery, C, all major credit and debit cards accepted, it's ABC Electrical Sales, shop number 8, Hagley Park Plaza, Kingston 10, open Monday to Friday, 8 a.m. to 5 p.m., Saturday, 8 a.m. to 4 p.m. We make your electrical jobs as easy as ABC. Call 754-382-528 or fax 754-365. ABC Electrical Sales for a better choice.
Fearless and love more, 'cause you open up the door.
Live, camera, volume. Live It Up Fridays on Best 100 FM, 10 a.m. to 2 p.m. with I, Ibi Lion, each and every Friday, giving you the better vibes heard everywhere.
The Morning Connection is not your usual talk show. We aim to stimulate discussion and chart new paths to self-empowerment. So please join us, Minette and Percy, on The Morning Connection, Mondays to Thursdays, 6 a.m. to 10 a.m. on Best 100 FM.
It's good. It's better. But nothing beats.
Good morning. Good morning to you. Welcome to The Morning Connection. This is your host, Percival Palmer, joined online by my co-host for this week, Pastor Michael Akin. Good morning, Michael. How are you doing?
Good morning, my brother. I'm trying to stay warm.
You're trying to stay warm. I guess we could say the same thing here in Kingston. You know, you have to be under the blankets and everything. I didn't get that.
We're going to postpone this, the program because of the cold.
No, sir. We got to keep going. We got to keep going.
What life is all about, indeed. Working through even the difficult moments. Making the choice to do so.
Yes, sir. It is so. And making the choice to do so. And this week, Mike, we have been on a journey. For those who have been with us this week, we started this week in regards to how important it is for leadership, and we started in Exodus with Jethro visiting his son-in-law Moses, and he saw what he was doing. He was the leader of the children of Israel, having just come out of Egypt into the promised land. And he was the one who was the main person. And Jethro sat and says, what you are doing is not well. Look for men who fear God. That was one of the characteristics.
Men of truth.
Men who know the truth. Men who do not take
dishonest gain.
No, make dishonest gain.
Right, man.
Right. And then the following day, we looked. The theme was mind games. How important it is that you are able to look at information and be able to discern in terms of what is true and what is lie.
Yes.
And yesterday we went into the Proverbs. We went into the Proverbs looking at Proverbs 4 and verse 23. In terms of where your heart, as a man thinketh in his heart, so is he becoming. And today I want to us to reflect on choices, the choices that we make. Because having done all of that, I think we are, again, in a moment where we have to be making choices. What do you think?
Yes, that is so. That is so indeed. You know, I'm reminded of a statement by an American pastor called Vance Havner that says, life is a series of choices between the bad, the good, and the best.
The bad, the good, and the best. Is that where we are at in Jamaica? Choice between the bad, the good, and the best?
Yeah, I mean, and here we end that posit. Everything depends on which we choose. Let me say it again. Life is a series of choices between the good, the bad, and the best. Everything depends on which we choose. I hope we in Jamaica wake up to that. That is a fact of life. That's how God has ordered his business in this created world.
Yeah.
Our choices are really what determine what's ahead of us and what we're going through right now. And we're part of a country, you know, Pastor P, I don't know if you realize, where we spend so much time blaming external things, blaming other issues instead of looking closely at the choices we make.
The choices we make on a daily basis.
Yeah, man, especially as religious people. Why we love blame the devil? Everything is the devil. Let me do this, or the devil did this, or this. Now, don't get it twisted. I'm not disparaging the supernatural at all. Mm-hmm. It exists.
Right.
I do believe that we overlook too much the power of our choices. God has given us the ability to determine.
But that's something that he never took from us, Mike.
Huh?
That's something that he never took from us.
Never took.
Yes, he gave it to us.
Yeah, man.
Yeah.
Stop blame other people or the devil or whatever for your choices. Yeah. Examine choices carefully and make them accordingly.
Right. So it means that you have to look at the information that is before you. We can't close our eyes to the issues that are there and determine, as I always say, the choices that I make is not only for myself and my children, but for my grandchildren, and what are the long-term implications of the choice that I make. So the children of Israel, Mike, had come. Joshua had led them. He had become the leader after Moses, and he was a person who led them into the promised land. And Joshua 1, 8 and 9, he gets some specific instructions in terms of how he should be. First thing, do not be afraid. It's interesting that every time God is about to do something, he says, do not be afraid. Because I say to people a lot of times, you always move in faith. The kingdom of Satan is one that is rooted in fear. And become very, very fearful. And he told him, don't be afraid. You're about to move into some new things. And I'm going to be with you, but you have to meditate on this law that I'm giving you day and night, so that your way will be right and you will get good success.
Yes, indeed. Formula for success.
Yes. So he gives us, he gives us, he says to us, yesterday we focused on what God is about. He's about righteousness. He's about justice. He's about truth and mercy. And those are things that we must look for in persons that we ask to lead. Are they righteous in the decisions? Are they people who are just? Are they people who speak the truth all the time? And are they merciful in terms of their interactions with individuals? One of the other things we looked at, another scripture we looked at, even as we make choices, it says, God says, there are things that I don't like. So I'm putting my finger on Joshua 24, because that's where I'm going to meditate from today, and then we look at what's happening in current affairs. But
while you put your finger on it, can I throw in another aspect that we should consider that didn't come out between Monday to today?
Yes, what's that?
And that's the aspect that we should look for persons also who are visionary in their mindset, or not afraid to follow a vision. Remember now, you know, Joshua was actually following a vision that began
with
years
Abraham.
Before him.
Abraham.
When the Creator appeared to a fairly wealthy man in a part of the world called Ur, and said to him, this is what I'm going to do with you. And from our human perspective, persons around him would have really considered that as something almost supernatural. You know, when God met with this human being and outlined to him a new vision for himself and his family. And that continues today, in perhaps maybe not, sometimes not in such a powerful supernatural way, but God speaks to leaders and speaks to persons to lead in a visionary manner, something that's outside of the box sometimes. And even as we look at this, the unraveling of that powerful story, when those Hebrew people in Egypt began to pull together now as a nation after their great-great-great-grandfather had this vision that set a new way forward.
Okay.
You realize that that man Moses, the first prime minister, if you will, or president of the Hebrews, first leader, had to make a choice.
Right.
He was in a situation where he was comfortable, but it says, that, if you remember, I think it says by faith, when Moses had grown up,
okay,
chose to renounce his title mm-hmm. son of Pharaoh's daughter, and chose instead to stand with the people because he was looking ahead. I think that's recorded in Hebrews chapter 11. I throw that in because I think as we look, as you encourage us to look for leaders of integrity, and we also need to look for leaders who have a vision for this nation, somebody who believes it's more important to put Jamaica first than their own desire for personal enrichment and power. Yesterday we spoke about the fact that those two issues seem to be the driving forces behind all politicians, no matter
which side of the fence they're on.
Which side of the fence they're on. Power or money. But yet, the Bible says this man, Moses, when he had grown up,
He made a choice.
I won't hold on to the fact that I am the son of Pharaoh's daughter. That would have been something of worth for him. He instead chose to stand with his people. But here's why. Because he was looking ahead, looking at the future, looking at the vision where God going with them. Boy, I hope we'd have leaders who can catch a vision of a new Jamaica, a reimagined Jamaica, a Jamaica where everyone is treated with the kind of first-class treatment that politicians get and rich people get. Everybody honored and respected, no matter which office they step into, a service, a place, a reimagined Jamaica, a new Jamaica where we're producing goods and service for the national economy, for our GDP, where the whole of we can get piece of the pie, Pastor Percy, and not just 1% of the country. A Jamaica where everywhere is safe, like Portland.
But Portland is no longer a safe place. Because you have gone up
to the island, man. We are the lowest crime rate.
Right.
So we're, and by the way, you know, we got the JCF out here under the leadership of Darby, I think his name is. But I, you know, sometimes I move closer with them. They keep good tabs on what's going on to make sure that the peace continues, even though some try to disrupt that. But can we this morning also suggest that when we choose persons who, of course, have a good national
vision people of integrity.
Man. Yeah, man.
People have integrity.
By the way, there's something called, don't we still have something called the Vision 2030 plan?
Yeah, man.
National Development Plan?
Jamaica is a place to live, work, and raise families. The place of choice. So it's not only for Jamaicans, but people probably want to come here. And I think that's going to happen.
Place of choice.
Yeah,
yes.
To live, work.
So we go to live, work.
Raise families.
Raise families.
And do business.
Keep your doors open and do business.
Keep your doors open and do business. You are playing there. Anyway.
Well, there's a prime minister who promised us that he would be able to control crime in such a way that we could open our doors.
Well, unfortunately, I think he was being aspirational.
Yes, and that's good.
By the way,
he was drawing that, I'm sure, from Portland.
Okay.
Somebody visited me once and realized the door was unlocked. And I said, yo, man, over here, sometime we're not locked door. We have to lock it now, though, you know, just to let you know. But there was a time when I was growing up here and up to when I returned from the
States.
USA that nobody not went trouble you things, but no. We certainly have had a transformation in the wrong direction that we need to correct. So let's choose to correct it.
Okay. All right. Yes. So in the choosing and the choices we are making, and we're just projecting forward as we speak to the listening public, the first thing, you're going to make a choice. But what is the basis for making a choice? You look at individuals who are honest, people with integrity, persons who don't look for bribe, and those who fear God. That's what came out of the Exodus passage. But yes. Today, again this morning, there are 6 things the Lord hates. No, 7 things he detests. Haughty eyes, a lying tongue, hands that kill the innocent, a heart that plots evil, feet that race to do wrong, a false witness who pours out lies, a person who sows discards into a body. That is NLT. But the Amplified even breaks it down. It says, these six things the Lord hates, indeed, seven are an abomination to him. And even as we do the spotlight on leadership, we have to also do the spotlight on ourselves, because we know that our country is dependent on us holding our leaders accountable. But you can't hold somebody accountable if you are not practicing the same thing. Does that make sense?
Yes, it does. It does. Yeah. Yes.
So one of the things that I'm seeing happening, we get leaders who represent us. Is that a fair statement?
Very fair statement.
And so our leaders reflect who we are in the general population.
True.
And if we are determined that we say, oh, we are a Christian country, then my challenge to us as people who say we are a Christian country is to, in our behavior, practice that way. So, a proud look, a spirit that makes one overestimate himself and underestimate others, right?
Yeah.
A lying tongue, that means we must stop tell lie. In whatever situation we find ourselves, talk truth. My mother and my grandmother would say, speak the truth and speak it ever, cause it what it may.
Yes.
Hands that
you
shed.
The wrong he does.
Yes.
Does the wrong thing still.
Say that again, because we're losing that.
Yes.
Speak the truth.
We're not teaching those mantras anymore.
In the children.
Right. Speak the truth and speak it ever. Cost you what it will. He who hides the wrong he does the wrong thing still.
So, and that is reflection. If you tell lies, you have to continue to tell lies because you don't even remember what it said the thing the other time. And it is something even as men, and in our relationships with each other, we have to talk truth to the power. A heart that manufactures wicked thoughts and plans. A heart that manufactures wicked thoughts and plans. Feet that are swift in running to evil. And we know what evil is. A false witness who breathes out lies even on the oath. It's kind of interesting that in two of the seven hits, it speaks to our conversation, the things that we say to other. And he who sows discord. That's the third thing. So three out of them has to do with what we say, what we speak. And that is important, because you have pointed out to us, even in conversations, and we spoke about mind games in terms of the narrative that is out there that people try to confuse and cause for mix-up in terms of what is said. And they're not speaking the truth. They know they're not speaking the truth. They know they're telling lies, and they still say it. And that is reflected in even some... Where I think I'm the minister of information, that's Mr. Morgan, has to be backtracking, because he said something about Mr. Ratigan. And Mr. Ratigan said, I'm going to sue you. And you know about that?
Yes, I know about it very well, very well.
Yeah, so he
knows Mr. Ratigan very well, sir.
And he knows what he was saying was not true.
Right.
And Mr. Ratigan said, really, no?
You see, Pastor P, when you choose to make decisions based on what is expedient,
yes,
or an outcome that you want that suits your pocket or suits your party, then you will lie to achieve that.
Mm-hmm.
And we somehow have to get to our people in general, and then our leaders in particular, to help them realize that don't make sense.
Yeah.
You can't continue to choose to do the same foolishness.
Until we're going to get a different outcome.
Every month, every week, every day. All for the sake of either...
Power?
Gaining some power, making some money.
Mm-hmm.
You know, as you said, this is the only culture that I've experienced. Having maybe lived in about three.
Mm-hmm.
Where somebody will give Michael and Percy the chance to make $1 million.
Mm-hmm.
And we are good friends, you know,
mm-hmm.
colleagues.
Mm-hmm.
But yet in the process of making that money,
mm-hmm.
I will choose to kick away your feet or you will choose to kick away mine because
tell that
we
you.
Want the money. Friendship don't count. Christianity don't count. I want to get the money, so I will hurt my friend to do so. Never seen that before. Now, here's what I experienced, especially in the U.S. You will give two people in the U.S. a chance to make $1 million. They don't even speak to each other. And for the time it takes to make $1 million, they will speak back to each other. Then when they each get their $500,000 check, they malice again. But out here, we will choose to destroy friendships just to gain money or gain power. Mm. I just don't understand what socialized us in that direction.
Yeah.
And then here's another thing, if you don't mind me throwing this in the conversation. I had to speak to a group of young men on this very same issue, making choices in life. And I drew on their blackboard in their classroom, imagine a highway, you know, and it had roads leading off of it. And then I put at the, after asking them, you know, what are some of their desires in life? What do they want to become? And people would say, I want to be a soldier, I want to be a doctor, I want to be a teacher. So I put those things at the top of the end of the highway. And then at the bottom, of course, is where we are right now in the classroom. And the roadway is going off. I said, we're going to name these roadways, things that can take us off the highway to where we want to go. So let's name the first little roadway taking us off the highway. And I had explained to them what I'm doing. So I'm expecting them going to name things like doing something bad and going to prison or anything that can distract somebody from a pathway of getting where they want to. And the first child said, bad mind, sir. I said, okay, bad mind?
Okay.
Well, okay, all right, let me put it down since you said it. Okay, what other thing can distract you from your goal in life? Another one said, bad mind, sir. I said, hold up. We got that already. Tell me something that can, for example, I said, let's say part of you being a success means that you've got to go study abroad. So you have to get your student visa. The night before you're going to the embassy to get start your testing process and so on, you smoke ganja and drop asleep and don't wake up on time and you're late and that mess up your whole situation. All right, you chose to do that. What you can call that? Bad mind, sir. I said, wait, no, man, no, no, no.
Let's talk with bad mind.
Yes,
bad mind, I kill them.
The reason why I chose to smoke ganja and fall asleep.
Bad mind.
Come out. It's because somebody bad mind me.
And what was their response?
In my head, the principal was in the room. I just shrugged their shoulders. After she spoke to me, she said, Pastor, no, you know what we have to deal with now. We cannot get them to focus on right choices because they believe everything is either bad mind or we have something.
Are you serious? What age were these children?
We're talking about children in, middle school is what I know it as from abroad, but out here is
primary school.
College school, yes.
You mean they're college in grade school. 7,
we're
8, 9?
11, 12, 14.
Yeah, bad mind.
Yeah, so they so bad mind.
So they don't that take risk. They don't take responsibility for the choices that they have made.
No.
It's always about somebody trying to do something against them.
Yes, sir.
All right. And
the listener needs to get out of that.
Yeah, well, everybody.
Construct today.
Every single one of us. We don't hold ourselves accountable for the choices that we make. And then afterward, it's somebody else. It's the devil made me do it. But that's not it. We are ultimately responsible. And we have to take account for our actions and what it is that we do. And then whatever choice you make, you got to live with that choice.
Live with it.
You have to live with that choice.
Those consequences by making better choices.
Right. So, and that is what we're talking about. When we come back, we're going on a break. We have some guests this morning that will come on after or the 8 o'clock news. We have JPS got this morning. JPS normally comes on at 8:30. So I'm just giving a heads up to our caller who normally call in at 8. We're not going to be taking your calls until about 9 o'clock this morning as we seek to, as it were, focus on what you need to do, what you must do in terms of the choices you make on a daily basis. And choices is something that God has given us. We have free will. We need to be making good choices. I wanted to repeat that quote in terms of the pastor. What did he say again? Good, bad, and what? The choice you make.
Life is a series of choices between the good, the bad, and the best. Everything depends on which we choose.
Life is. And I think as Jamaicans, as we go, as we run up to the local government elections, which is on Monday, there are choices that people have to make. Between the good, the what? The good?
The good, the bad, and the best.
The good, the bad, and the best choice for you as you are thinking long-term. The choice will determine what is it that you want. How is it that you see this country going forward as an individual? It's now 7 o'clock. When we come back, we will look at what has been said by Joshua when he was saying, all right, guys, we are at this point. Moment of decision, what will you choose? So when we come back, this is your host, Pastor Percival Palmer, on The Morning Connection as we continue to look at things that are happening in the nation, but also passing on principles that you can apply personally at home, at school, in your communities, and nationally as we select who our local government counselors will be at this point in time when we come back.
Best 100 FM, broadcasting live in all 14 parishes. Hanover 100.5, 100.9. St. James 100.9. Trelawney 100.3, 100.9. St. Anne 100.3, 100.5. St. Mary 100.5. West Milan 100.1, 100.5. St. Elizabeth 100.1, 100.5. Manchester 100.1, 100.5. Clarendon 100.1, 100.5, 100.9. St. Catherine 100.5, 100.9. St. Andrew 100.5, 100.9. St. Thomas 100.5, and 100.9. Best FM, giving you the better vibe.
FM 100 on your dial. Keep listening.
The following is a radio drama brought to you by the Child Protection and Family Services Agency, CPFSA.
Annie? Wow! I have not seen you in ages.
Oh my gosh! Yes! It's certainly been a long time, eh? I haven't seen you since what, we finished university?
I think so. I think the last time I saw you was when you had just started working at that place with Child Development Agency or something like that.
Yes, it is now the Child Protection and Family Services Agency.
Sorry. It's like God let me run into you today because I need some help with my daughter, Candy.
Really? How old is she now?
She's 12, man, and of late, it's like she's a whole new person. I don't know what to do with her. She get lazy. She stopped doing her school work. She looking into space all the time. And it's like, me and her father, we can't talk to her. The least little thing, she lashes out at us. And I'm feeling so frustrated.
That's definitely not normal behavior at all, you know. Have you spoken to her teacher at school to find out if she's also noticing these changes?
Yes, I went by her school and spoke with the guidance counselor. She's going to try and assist us to get some counseling for Candy.
Yes, because what you just described to me could be signs of something going wrong mentally. Worst case scenario, her mental health and well-being might be deteriorating.
No, Annie, what? Mental health? Deteriorating? But how can that be possible? And we try our best to give her everything. No, man, it cannot be that.
Susan, the pandemic has impacted our children more than we could ever imagine. With the shift from in-person classes to online learning, many children lost their safe space among their peers. Some of them, parents lost their jobs and the home situation changed. We've had to be dealing with even more cases at the office than usual.
Seriously? Candy's definitely going through something and I don't know what it is.
Remember, the school has promised to help. But you can take her to a specialist like a psychologist or a psychiatrist who can provide professional help.
Really? I didn't know children could just go to those doctors like that. But then again, I don't know if there is a need for that. Whatever she's going through will eventually go away, don't it?
No, Susan. Mental health is no joke. These little things can grow into monsters if you don't get the help at the right time. At CPFSA, we're seeing an increase in the number of children in state care whose mental health and well-being have been impacted. To help address this issue, we've recently expanded our mental health services with a mobile unit through a partnership that we have with the Transformation Implementation Unit. This allows us to access state-of-the-art psychological tools to screen children and identify the best course of action to get them help. It's hard to hear that Candy's having these challenges, though, and you really should go get some help for her.
You know what, Annie? Yes, I really should. I had no idea this issue impacted so many of our young people, and I am beyond grateful for the advice you have given me today. I have to talk to her father, though, about it right away. We will do anything to help poor Candy.
Susan, you know I'm here to help in any way I can to ensure that Candy gets the help she needs. Come, let me give you my number, and you call me anytime to talk it through, okay?
Thank you so much, Annie.
That was brought to you by the Child Protection and Family Services Agency, CPFSA. Protecting children, empowering families, securing the future.
A stable family is the best environment for every child. At the Child Protection and Family Services Agency, CPFSA, we have made caring for our nation's children easier by making better use of information and communication technology in our processes. This includes integrating the National Children's Registry's processes into our case management system. As a result, staff can efficiently access case files and process cases promptly and seamlessly. We will also be equipping nurseries with sensory equipment to support the growth of children with special needs. The CPFSA, protecting children, empowering families, securing the future. Visit childprotection.gov.jm to learn more. This ICT expansion project is being implemented in collaboration with the Transformation Implementation Unit.
A production of the Jamaica Information Service, the voice of Jamaica.
What should a taxi service do for you? On-time taxi service is more than just a ride to the other side of town. They offer clean and spacious vehicles, reliable service, and promise to always look out for their customers. They'll come when you call and take you where you want to go on time.
We are something special on the road.
Vejam Printers for all your printing needs. We specialize in calendars, flyers, brochures, and more. Call us today at 968-7506. That's 968-7506. Or visit us at 4 East Bloomsbury Road, off Haggard Park Road. Vejam Printers, your best choice in printing.
Half a tree, one and drive, half a tree. Bossy, how do I take taxi star?
Jano, I want to tell you, say, at 2 months now, my transmission mash up, you know, and I check everybody and can't hear nothing positive.
Yeah, hear me? Yeah, waste all that time I shop around and never call the experts. Winters, auto, have them. Them have over 35 years of experience and them diagnose a problem and get back your transmission brand new. For them service excellent and efficient. Trust me, man. Yeah, hear me? Call them at 929-7040 or go to them at 106 Maxfield Avenue, Kingston 13 and talk directly to the boss. Just tell them I'm me send you.
You big star. Yeah, man, respect my boss.
Yeah, try calling, you know, trust me.
Winter's Auto Spares and Repairs, good afternoon.
Ah, what a relief.
Ready for the war, fear. Oh, yeah. Ready for the war.
Jamaica and the world. You want us back? We are back. The Breakthrough, Deliverance Ministry, led by me, the Prophet Mark Stewart, right here on Best 100 FM. This and every Thursday night, from 9 p.m. to 12 midnight. Yes, it's War Room Thursday. Come on out and join us, each and everyone, on Best 100 FM, 100.1, 3, 5, 7, and 9. Come on out.
Come on out.
Join me, the Prophet, Reverend Mark Stewart. And of course, the boss shot, Apostle Marshall, come for your healing, breakthrough, deliverance, the prayer, the miracle, the word, the testimony, and so much more. Yes, my friends, Best 100 FM, War Room Thursday, 9 p.m. to 12 midnight. Join us. We are going to lick it.
Greetings, brothers and sisters. I invite you to join us for the Church of Our Lord Jesus Christ radio program with Elder Kendrick Murray, where we stand firm that Jesus Christ is the Son of God. This broadcast is heard every Saturday from 12 noon to 1 p.m. and again on Sundays from 4 to 5 p.m. The church is located at 3550 Pleasant Valley Road, here in Mobile, Alabama, in the United States. You may visit our website at sonofgodlives.org or our YouTube page at Minister K. Murray. Or you may call us at air code 251-300-8812. God bless you, and we look forward to you tuning in to the program.
Do you need reliable health care? We have it.
Yes, we do. Great George Street Pharmacy, shop number 897 Great George Street, Savannah, Lamar, Westmoreland. Opening hours, Mondays to Saturdays, 8:30 a.m. to 6 p.m. Call us at 876-603-7372 or WhatsApp us at 876-205-0499. Yes, we have reliable health care for you at Great George Street Pharmacy, Savannah, Lamar.
Best 100 FM is the authentic voice of Jamaica, promoting your prosperity with better vibes and better music. Let us promote your goods and services for you. Advertise with us. For more information, call our office at 876-276-8935. That's 276-8935.
The Morning Connection is not your usual talk show. We aim to stimulate discussion and chart new paths to self-empowerment. So please join us, Minette and Percy, on The Morning Connection, Mondays to Thursdays, 6 a.m. to 10 a.m. on Best 100 FM.
It's good. It's better. But nothing beats. Best.
Life is one big road with
Life is one big road with lots of signs. Morning, Michael. How are you?
I continue to give God thanks for a new day, my brother.
Life is one big road with lots of signs. But when you listen to Marley music, and I encourage people to go and see this, the One Love movie, the biopic of Marley's life. I'm really focused between 76, 78, and with that turbulent point in our history. A lot of things on the side, but just to tell people that on the billboard, Marley is still there with One Love, and the songs, the soundtrack that was released is doing well. It has come in at 9 and 10, and of course, he's still number one on the billboard charts in terms of the reggae. So, his legacy lives on, and he made choices. Mike.
Yes, my brother.
You know that my older brother who is now deceased was a Rasta man. You know that, right? Did you know that?
No, I didn't know that.
Yes,
but
man,
that was why I was laughing. I was just reflecting on the fact. This is about 2024.
Yes.
And I'd say maybe about, 40 years ago?
Yes.
Two pastors or two clergymen, two religious people would never be on the radio.
Talking about Marley.
Or at home. Talking about I remember growing up, that was called devil music.
Oh, my brother. Reggae music was devil music.
Prophet without honor in his own countryman. But we have awakened.
Yeah.
We have awakened indeed.
And to understand the impact of it. And interesting, whether we like it or not, even as Reggae Month, which is coming to an end, was launched, I made a reflection. When you look at the early reggae music, and even the ones that is a conscious, a lot of it is Bible in a bridging.
Yes, man.
A lot of it is Bible.
Yes. Early Rastafarian.
Yes.
Which, again, to my eldest brother, walked down that roadway, and then he kind of made a, for want of a better word, compromise.
Mm-hmm.
By embracing the Ethiopian Orthodox Church.
Mm-hmm. Which my brother did at the end, right? Which is
yeah, it gave him a little bit of Rasta, a little bit of Orthodox Christianity.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, man. So they spend a lot of time in the Word of God.
Yeah, man, they do. And they know it better. If you're going to take on a Rasta man who is a Bible man, you better know your Bible.
I tell you something. When my brother passed away, you know, Pastor Percy, this is an aside, but when he passed away, of course, the Ethiopian Orthodox Church is the church that was responsible for his funeral, but they don't have one out here. Okay?
They
but
do,
the
man.
Family wanted it out here. So I called the priest at the Ethiopian Orthodox Church, and I said, listen, the building here of our local brethren church that my father started is available to you. And don't feel afraid to come and to engage the rituals that you would in your church.
Mm-hmm.
And then I took on the two church elders and said to them, could you please honor God by allowing them to engage what they want to? It is not your business if them going to put incense in the church, the Holy Spirit not going to vex, God not going to be upset because they depart from your brethren traditions.
Mm-hmm.
Allow them. And Pastor Percy, it was a wonderful memorial. Because I don't know if you know, some of it was engaged in old
Orthodox
Aramaic.
I know.
Yes.
Mike, that's what happened with my brother. He became a part of the Ethiopian Orthodox Church is a Christian church. It is older than the Western church that we know. And
yes,
it is a black church. So, and that's what happened. That's how we buried my brother. They came to where I'm at, and they did everything. They were a part of it in terms of the incense and all of that. In regards to it. As we talk about choices, go out and vote. Election watchdog urges Jamaicans to take polls seriously as survey reveals voter apathy remains high, meaning 41% of people not interested in voting. But that means that 59%, when you add up very interested, somewhat interested, ambivalent, that is 59%. So, And with what is happening, I am sensing, and I'm going to say this, I am not a pollster or anything. I guess tomorrow when the polls come out, who will win and so on, or on the weekend, because that's what normally happens, like 2-3 days before the election.
So you're not going to predict, you're not giving us a prediction. I was looking forward, Pastor Percy.
For me to prophesy? I'm not going to do that, because I don't hear anything. I will not prophesy or do anything like that. But I am saying that the turnout will probably be over 50% for this election, which would be very good when you consider all of what is happening in terms of the national and the local body politic. So I'm this lady on the front page. I said, you need to choose. Okay, her name is Grace Baston. She is the chairperson of Citizens Action for Free and Fair Election. She's saying, go and vote. Turn out in your numbers, vote, and not give up on the democratic process. And that is what we are being saying. Is that correct, my brother?
Yes, indeed.
And it's our money. $1.7 billion enough money, you know. That could have done enough things in terms of school and put some money in early childhood education and so on.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, so we need to go out and
Pastor
vote.
P, I wanted to appeal directly to those who consider themselves God seekers and people who are spiritually aware.
Mm-hmm.
And the Christian man and the Rasta man and the Christian woman and the Rasta woman.
Everybody.
Because those are, especially I realize, disconnected from the political process. You know, Rasta call it Babylon, and I don't know what Christian call it, but we don't want to.
we call it corrupt.
Yes. Somehow we think both can't be parallel tracks, where you're pursuing God with your whole heart, but at the same time, you're involved as his representative and ambassador in the process of life.
Mm-hmm.
It's almost a living thing. You can't disconnect. Mm-hmm. We have misunderstood the comment by the Apostle Paul about in the world and not of it.
No, man, we have to go vote. I've been saying it to
people.
Those who are hearing my voice across the length and breadth of this country, go and vote. It's a choice that you first make, and then you go and vote for the individual or the person who you think best represents what you want for this country and for your grandchildren. Whether you want it to be, what is it now?
I thought when I heard you strongly saying, go and vote.
Mm-hmm.
I thought you were going to end up by saying, go and vote for, and then you give them one of the acronyms, PNP or GLP. Sorry, I was expecting that.
No, I'm not going to do that.
My apologies, my brother.
I'm trying to draw you out,
but you're not giving
me draw.
Out.
You're not drawing me out. Michael,
yes.
The Commissioner of Police contract comes down in end of March. And it don't look like him going back.
Choice, you think, or political choice?
I don't know. I'm looking at job well done. This SSP Diaries. I don't know who that it is. In my humble opinion, I don't know who this is. He says he was appointed in March 2018 and will have completed 6 or more years in JCF if the information going the circuit is correct. In my humble opinion, he is undoubtedly one of the best commissioners.
I agree with that commentary.
One of the best.
The problem is he doesn't have the PR machinery like the governing party does. If he, you there?
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, man, if he ever had the PR machinery, because he has made some really, really good choices behind the scenes that will affect the way we do policing and security here in a positive manner. It has already begun. But, of course, because the whole issue of crime and violence is still so much of a giant in this country, mm-hmm. because of the related political issues,
mm-hmm.
and the fact that people who ought to know better are involved in encouraging some of these young males to be violence producers instead of producers of goods and services for the national economy. We who are just normal people don't understand the intricacies and complexities of all of that. So we just look at the outcome. Man gets shot last night, gang warfare out in a Spanish town. Oh, he's not doing a good job. If I ever understand, you know, some of the issues.
Okay,
The very first gun in a Pastor Percy.
Yes, mate.
That was handed to me on my veranda by a young male who had reached a transforming moment in his life. And he came on my veranda and said, Pastor, could you please turn this in for me?
Oh, Pastor still do that kind of thing?
I accompanied him to the police station. And on the way, he pointed to the gentleman who had given him the gun. And I am still in shock.
Given him the
gun. Who was never to the inside of a jail cell. Because he's this well-dressed business suit, private sector, upstanding businessman in the community. Who we would allow to preach from our platform. This little gun carrier boy, you know, could never come in our church and sit anywhere except the back row. Vilified for his violence production. But the man who
gave him the gun,
provided the machinery for him.
Yeah.
Well respected. Until we stop those things, there is nothing a commissioner can do. Except engage a policy. If I was commissioner, here's what I would do, Pastor Percy. I would fight for policy that would link the gun user with the gun provider. In other words, if Pastor Percy shoots somebody on the road,
ask him who gave him the gun.
Yes, man. Let's set up a unit that track is able to track and spend time finding out where Pastor Percy got that gun. And if Percy goes to jail for a year because of the robbery he committed with the gun.
The man who gave him the gun.
And then Pastor Michael gave him the gun. Without trial, he gone to jail for 1 year or two. So once you link gun user with gun provider, we will cut some of these links that contain this shame of crime and violence in our country.
So, Michael, let me ask you a question. Do you think that is so powerful? Do you think that the powers that be on both sides know who is providing the guns? Because,
yes, sir.
Mike.
Yes, they do.
So why don't we go after them instead of going after the small fries? The same thing with drugs, you know. Let me just raise something that I continue to speak about. Over a year and a half ago, there's a major drug find at Ian Fleming. And it was in the papers.
Yes, man. $5 billion worth of money of drugs.
And we've not heard anything in terms of anybody lock up or why are you laughing? It's serious, you know. It's same like with SSL.
I know, but I laugh because, why, Pastor Percy, if you ever know the complexities of some of these things.
No, but the complexities
I know you're trying to draw me out because I was going to tell you, you know who we must go and ask about that?
The commission.
You're not say it over
the commissioner of police. The commissioner of police?
No, sir.
The investigating officers?
His hands are clean.
The deputy commissioner of police, Fitz Bailey? Ask him. Because,
as I said to some police officers who spoke to me harshly, because I had witnessed a guns for drugs drop in this part of the country at 3 o'clock one Sunday evening, but I did not report it until a few days had passed because I had family with me, and I didn't want to endanger their lives. When I finally reported it, the officer kicked up. Reverend, how you take so long for this? I said, sir, any young male in Jamaica who feels confident enough to get involved in that level of illegality at 3 o'clock in the evening, not 3 a.m., not under cover darkness, but in the bright sunlight of 3 o'clock, unashamedly involved in legal activity, That is a young male who feels protected. And only two professions give heavy protection here. Yours, sir, as the police, or the political director. Mm. So I dare not make decisions without that kind of consideration. Otherwise, midlife over, me know that. Mm-hmm. The little boy can't just decide, say, I'm going to get involved with some colleagues from Haiti in the bright mid 3 o'clock sun without thinking that I'm okay, I'm protected, I'm good.
So you have so
sometimes
said...
Sometimes you have to make wise
decisions. Wisdom, wise as you call it.
Chose not to engage because they were in full view right of my family. And if I had made a call, a police rushed out. You and I probably would not be on the phone right now.
Yeah, but Michael, so you have said that based on what has happened, and you are being above board and speaking with integrity, that... the police commissioner has done good work. Well, this is Speed Diary says that. The guy says, in my humble opinion, he is undoubtedly one of the best commissioners in the history of the JCF, an organization that impacts the lives of every single Jamaican daily. Under his tenure, he has quietly continued the modernization of the force through better strategic planning, resulting in greater efficiencies displayed in investigations, law enforcement professionalism, use of technology, public relations, interactions, communications, management of the thoroughfares, dress and deportment, interagency cooperation, among other critical areas too numerous to go into my limited on words and space. And he was relating to that. The Prime Minister said that serious crimes are down, lowest they have been in 22 years, and so on. Do you think, and he says, our commissioner has made his mark and he ought to be congratulated on his results-oriented management methodology through his tenure. They are bearing the desired fruit. Despite these observations, we have a break. It's SM30 when it was getting warm. We come back, don't leave us. We just continue the discussion as we think about choices that we have to make. They're going to have to choose a new commissioner soon, but in short order on the 26th of March, you're going to have to choose a new local government.
We want Ratigan.
You want Ratigan. Behave yourself.
I'm just kidding, but I know he made application.
But they never take him on. They never take him on. Yeah. Both sides. Anyway, so that's another thing. All right, then. When we come back. All right.
Grandpa, where are you going?
But see ya. I have business down by JPS, and I need Stephen to take me. I'm going to see what I owe and pay.
You don't have to leave the yard, Pops. Just call 888-225-5577.
You mean if you tell me, say, me not have to wait in line anymore?
We have recognized the number that you are calling from as being attached to account number 301842.
Watch ya. How them get me new number? How them know it's me?
Grandpa, I registered your account. So when you call from this phone, JPS already knows you and them just give you information.
Look where me live, Fissy. Thank God for you, young people.
For a better choice in all your electrical supplies, A, authorized 3M dealer and better brand names, B, better service including free island-wide delivery, C, all major credit and debit cards accepted, it's ABC Electrical Sales, shop number 8, Hagley Park Plaza, Kingston 10, open Monday to Friday, 8 a.m. to 5 p.m., Saturday, 8 a.m. to 4 p.m. We make your electrical jobs as easy as ABC. Call 754-3825-8 or fax 754-365. ABC Electrical Sales for a better choice.
Do you need reliable health care?
We have it.
Yes, we do. Great George Street Pharmacy. Shop number 897 Great George Street, Savannah, Lamar, Westmoreland. Opening hours, Mondays to Saturdays, 8:30 a.m. to 6 p.m. Call us at 876-603-7372 or WhatsApp us at 876-205-0499. Yes, we have reliable health care for you at Great George Street Pharmacy, Savannah, Lamar.
Following is a paid announcement by the Jamaica Labour Party.
The Jamaica Labour Party is building a healthier Jamaica for us all. This means more doctors, more nurses, more hospital beds, more diagnostic equipment, and more health centres. This means more access to healthcare for all Jamaicans. It also means shorter waiting times, less medical bills, more smiles, and more lives saved. Join us in building a healthier nation. The Jamaica Labour Party, building for you and your community.
This election day, vote Jamaica Labour Party.
The proceeding was a paid announcement by the Jamaica Labour Party.
For all your Honda Ridgeline parts in Kingston, call 326-7371 or 821-5232 now. We sell genuine shocks, power steering pumps, engine mount, fender liner, strut mount, front end parts, engine parts, electrical switches and sensors, and many, many more. Remember, we are your Honda Ridgeline parts dealer located in Kingston. Contact us now at 326-7371 or 821-5232 for more details.
Best 100 FM is the authentic voice of Jamaica, promoting your prosperity with better vibes and better music. Let us promote your goods and services for you. Advertise with us. For more information, call our office at 876-276-8935. That's 276-8935.
The Morning Connection is not your usual talk show. We aim to stimulate discussion and chart new paths to self-empowerment. So please join us, Minette and Percy, on The Morning Connection, Mondays to Thursdays, 6 a.m. to 10 a.m. on Best 100 FM.
It's good. It's better. But nothing beats.
Yeah, as we conclude, the whole thing of justice and choices, I want to conclude the discussion in regards to Major. He says, in choosing the next commissioner, and that's something because one of the things we've called for is that the commissioner of police, like with the DPP, like with those offices, you need to, like in some countries, bring the people in front of the parliament that they can be asked questions. What do you think of that? That new arrangement in terms of what we would embed in our constitution, that they have public hearings, because here's what the person says. He's done a good job. Notwithstanding our policing, there are many of his that thing. There are problems ahead, he says, in transitioning of the leadership beyond Major General Anderson. In my opinion, both political parties will be responsible for ensuring that the JCF does not backslide at this critical juncture. The appointment to lead the organization to include those immediately impacted by the ripple effect within the police structure must be based upon merit and not political favors. Political interference has only served to destroy individual and collective capacities and capability since we gained independence. It's high time that our political master desist and do better. The force needs to be put into a position where it can continue along a consistent progressive path. If it fails after the foundation has been so adequately set, then the nation can rest assured that it will plunge into the greatest disaster suffered since the days of slavery. What say you?
Excellent commentary there, but all right, let's be real for a moment.
Yes.
I believe in realistic outcomes in whatever pursuit of life. Mm-hmm. If you give me a task to do and I ask you, okay, what is the end game, Pastor Percy? What are the outcomes you desire? Mm-hmm. When you tell me, my next job is to determine what's realistic and what's not, given all the parameters in the context of operation. All right, I don't think, first of all, that we will ever get to a point where Pastor Percy, Pastor Michael, the Prime Minister, anybody will make a choice of employment for a critical position in the public service or in pastoral service without some prejudicial consideration.
Yeah, but you're a person of integrity.
Yes, but we're in a man, but let's get that firstly out of our mind. Stop appealing to our political leaders to choose people to lead in critical national positions.
We're not favorable to them.
Consideration.
Call them political stripes.
Is allied to me politically. There is nothing wrong with political alliance.
All right. But
as long as it is accompanied
by
national allegiance. In other words, Michael can be allied to a political party, but his allegiance must be to Jamaica.
Okay.
Okay. So let's get that out of the way. It is okay if you appoint a commissioner who is much closer to your political philosophy than mine. I accept that.
But
however, based on the other criteria that you mentioned between Monday to today regarding leadership.
Mm-hmm. I'm enough.
Once we get that out of the way, we must make a choice now between the bad, the good, and the best. Put somebody in there with integrity. There's a particular commission, I'm told, who lacked so much integrity that the feds abroad had to step in and say, move him.
Oh, and take him out? We know that.
No, I can't call a name. Otherwise, SFM probably will be under some fire, and myself, so to speak. But I am sure those who appointed that person would have known that he lacked integrity.
And they still did it.
There are some Christians that I would not invite to a position like that if it was my job. For example, I know a good Christian person who I love very much, who stood up in his job abroad and allowed some young males to send guns down here. And when I appealed to him and said, how could you have done that? You're a man of God. He gave some flippant excuse.
Okay.
Because I'm friendly. Now, I use those, Pastor Percy, as much as I love you and appreciate you. If I find out that you lack integrity in a particular area of life, I'm not going to put butter in front of puss mouth, man. I'm not going to give you a job.
You're not going to put butter in front of puss mouth. So the question of integrity is a major one.
Pass the political alliance.
Yeah.
Then go for the man with the best integrity.
Mm-hmm.
Right? The man with the best wisdom. Mm-hmm. And you can know that by checking their choices over the past. You know, you know that we have this thing that if you're faithful in little things, then you will be faithful in big things. We overlook the power of that principle, you know.
Mm-hmm.
Because here's what I have found. The beauty of this country is that anyone can rise to leadership here. In other countries, you have to have a certain name brand. You have to have a certain bloodline. In Jamaica, a peanut seller can become prime minister.
Okay. All right.
Which means that the peanut seller, if he's a short pants, dirty wearing alcoholic when you're selling peanuts, when he becomes prime minister, don't think that will change unless he has engaged the process of transformation before him get the position. But we keep putting in place some people who we know when they were running a patty shop, they ran it down. But somehow we think that that would make
the difference.
A good minister.
Okay. So what you are speaking about is integrity of the person, which is important.
Yes, ma'am.
How important then is that even as we switch gears again, because we've looked at the commissioner and we go back to what will happen in terms of local government. Because whether we like it or not, it really has turned into a national election. In terms of how it has been positioned in people's minds. You listen to the ads on the radio. You're hearing about health. I don't know how health. health. You see a lot of announcements. Hearing about health and things. So in everybody's mind,
the presence of political bigwigs on the ground in locales that you go why is he visiting here?
Yeah,
because yeah, man, usually the process is this. The real top-notch ministers and so on don't usually do some heavy groundwork unless the constituency wants to be won and they think that they are lagging. Then you see the big names, the vice presidents and the presidents visiting to stir up alliances.
Mm.
And I'm really shocked at the way both parties are using their bigwigs on the ground.
On the ground, over the place.
This is a national election.
Okay, it's a national election. So, indeed, 9 years ago, and people don't know this, that local government law, which was passed, I think it was, it's Portia did it, with the municipal.
Regarding what?
In terms of putting it in the constitution. Indeed, 9 years ago, Jamaica sought on its face to give deeper expression. I'm reading from the Gleaner editorial now to that ideal by anchoring local government in the island's constitution. Because before it wasn't, you know.
Right.
And they did that. So yeah. Kudos to them that they did that. 9 years ago would have been 9 years from 2015. Yeah.
Mm-hmm.
It was put into the constitution, right? But now it put it in by saying, okay, what people pay in terms of land taxes go directly to local government. But in terms of making sure that it goes there and it's given on time, that has not happened. And that is why it looks so bad.
Yeah.
And in the local issue, parochial roads, garbage collection, all of them things. A quick thing though, do you think that Vibes Cartel, it was the big thing and what happened, do you believe that what's going to happen? Because that's a bigger issue in terms of privy council. Because you know what I found fascinating with it? One of the lawyers who represented, who was on the team representing Vibes Cartel, him is a known Pan-Africanist, you know. Someone wondering why you got to Privy Council.
Well, you know, I'm not so sure why you injected this aside right here, but I think I'm going to reserve my comments on this one.
You're waiting until the Privy Council make them thing.
Yes, sir, yes. But
I tell you, you know, you see this thing of integrity, brethren.
It's something else, man.
It is something else because.
And Pastor Percy, let me say this carefully. If you knew half of what I know, you would be in Jamaica right now.
Okay.
We lack integrity at a national level so much.
Okay.
But I think I told you already. I mean, I was in a national meeting, and accused of too easily selecting truth telling as a thing to do. Today I'm still in shock.
No,
that I would tell the truth on a matter that you asked me and appoint me to deal with.
Mm-hmm.
I was successfully dealing with the issue, right? It was something with the government and a vendor.
No, lie, man. We tell lie.
And the man named Sammy shouldn't tell the truth about it.
We tell lie.
And even my Jesus tell lie. I can't forget that comment.
Oh, Jesus, he tell lie?
Well, when I said, well, my response to the person was, you know, on matters of Jesus, I think I probably would know a little bit more than you, but
they say that Jesus is tell lie.
Tim said on the road to a mill, when the record of scripture says he made as if he would go on.
Them say lie did tell. Lie did I tell.
Them say lie that sir.
All right.
So my response was, you know what? Even if Jesus told lie, he can't do it without sin.
Mm-hmm.
But me and my humanity can't do that. So I will choose to tell the truth best as I can.
Okay. All right. For the next, before we go into 8 o'clock, and thank you for joining us this week. 3 months ago, Howard Mitchell was honored.
Yes,
was honored by the PSOG and inducted into the
Hall of Fame.
Right. But he said some very interesting comments.
Powerful things.
Some very powerful things. And we, and even as we move towards this local government elections, we have to listen to what he has said, you know, because I don't know if people understand who is Howard Mitchell. Who, to your mind, who is this gentleman?
Because he even with all his accolades, he doesn't have the kind of PR that Minister Morgan runs for the current government. So he wouldn't be well known among young males and females out the street, because.
But just describe him. But who is this gentleman? He's been an advisor to both political parties.
Yes.
And he's chaired boards for them too.
Yeah.
So he said basically that it is so important that we safeguard institutions, and he spoke about a national values and attitudes campaign, which PJ had introduced, and people had laughed at him, laughing to scorn. And you were a part of a thing that not sought to reintroduce that under national transformation. What were the main points to you in terms of what Howard Mitchell said when he was honored?
Well, of course, he made a point about putting aside the tribalism that now is such a cultural part of how we deal with and respond to any matter nationally. Mm-hmm. And I really believe in that we need to do that. Even in here's something that I noticed, and it's our fault too. When I say our, I mean people like you and me, normal persons, because we encourage the parties to do that. But whenever something is achieved, even when it's just a basic amenity, but something that affects us nationally, we tend to take sides. Mm-hmm. You know, built by Labour, you know, or a PNP do that. Mm-hmm. When really we shouldn't have that kind of partisan approach to national matters of importance. Mm-hmm. For example, I think it was Canute Thompson who just pointed out that this idea of reconstructing UHWI, the University Hospital of West Indies,
it's not a new thing.
Yeah, it's not a new thing.
2015,
so, for the Prime MOG. Minister and the JLP to claim that it's their baby, he was saying is incorrect, because it's from way back in, was it 2000?
When Ferguson, yeah.
Under a different government, yeah. Mm-hmm. Now, we embrace it as people, then intelligent persons, like the Prime Minister and the Leader of Opposition, will continue it and embrace it and want accolades for it, when really it's deceit. It really is deceit. It's part of the line that God same hate. Mm-hmm. Because if I hold on to and expect an accolade for something that you did, Pastor P, at Feltab, mm-hmm. I really am putting myself in that abomination category that God speaks of. Mm-hmm. What I should do, in fact, is shake your hand, embrace you, and say to the people of Feltab, we did this. Not try to get some political points out of it. That is political immaturity of the highest level. Gets back to the comment I made that said, if you have short pants when you are a patty shop seller, you know, becoming Prime Minister don't mean you're going to lose your short pants. You're just going to wear it nationally. All right? So, I tell you that long story because I think he began his commentary on the Jamaican issues by saying, set aside the PNP-JLP thing. Of course, it's easy for him to say because he kind of straddles the fence. His value is so high that both parties see worth in him and have accordingly
abuse him. So
mad value.
So listen to this. Okay. He says, and I'm quoting from the Gleaner article, this was November 20, 3 months ago, but I put it to you that we are in the grave danger of failure as a nation, as a society, as a community of soul. We are hell-bent on self-destruction because of our culture of selfish and divisive tribalism, which steadfastly ignores value unless it is clothed in green or orange.
Yep.
We practice the doctrine of divide and rule that was practiced upon us for many years by our past slave masters, and refuse to acknowledge the damage that we now do to our future. We steep ourselves in the culture of piracy and mayhem and theft, which is so ingrained in our beginnings, but will be the cause of the end of us as a functional society.
Wow.
And we blame it on everything but our own refusal to establish for ourselves the values and attitudes that are critical in survival and to true prosperity. Yep. More recently, we are treating lives as commodities to be bought and sold by contract, and we have substituted brutality and perversion for reasoned dialogue and loving correction. Unfortunately, the pronouncements and behaviors of some of our political leaders encourage our less progressive elements to actions and attitude that take us further down the slippery slope to hell, good churchman. And even more unfortunately, there's little or no chastisement and accountability from their peers. A country with no beliefs, with centrality of established values is a body without a brain, a computer without an operating system, and no amount of hasty, inappropriately adopted legislation will change that. Morality cannot be legislated. It must be taught, encouraged, exemplified.
True.
And most importantly, it must be led. And when the laws that make the rule book by which we function and prosper are mocked, avoided, and flouted by leadership, when rules are applied selectively, enforced on the weak but not the strong, the gate to autocracy is open, and that spells doom in a society with immature institutions and confusing or non-existent values. I'm deeply concerned that Jamaica today fits that model. We are witnessing an unremitting, atavistic, and cannibalistic onslaught on our regulatory institution by other state entities that should be supportive rather than destabilizing. And I regret that much of our civil society appears either to be obviously asleep or compromised by complicity in the efforts of destruction of the social institutional framework of the country in order to maintain the status quo. Wow. That's a mouthful, you know. That's a mouthful. And so he says, no number of state emergencies can prevent the rising tide of contract killings and savage domestic violence. The first step has to be a positive manifestation of the majority of our civil institution and our citizens' desire to reverse the corrosive deviance in our social relationship. Civil society must speak up and speak now. Wow. My Lord.
And by the way, all that you have said there, you know,
is what you have been saying.
International data regarding the implosion of countries supports it, you know.
Yes.
In other words, if you were ever to take your listeners through research on what causes countries to implode, regardless of whether or not they are mostly black or white-led, you'll find that we're really heading down a slippery slope. Rwanda, Eritrea, Somalia, the Balkans, Argentina. The data supports exactly what he's saying, but then we elect leaders who look as if them just don't know history, don't know international politics, or they're just so overwhelmed by the desire to maintain state power and to get as much money as they can, which they cannot use before it dies.
And Michael, I have never done a funeral, and I've done many funerals, and there's not one person that I have seen that can carry it with them.
Not one, my brother.
And so what he has said, we have to think. So that is why, I've tried to express the message, and he talks about the Integrity Commission, the assault on it. He talks about what you have said in terms of enrichment of persons. He says the current constitutional reform appears to be majoring in the minors, playing a game of self-deceit while ignoring systematic efficiency, which frustrates. Boy, he said a mouthful, you know. I wonder if Jamaicans are listening, because this is a man who has come back from the brink, you know, because in terms of survival of the Big Sea, and is hearing him saying, you know, he's thinking about not only himself and his children, but his children's children, and him saying,
yeah,
stop it, make choices. As we do, we must make choices. There are choices that says, no, man, this thing are not working out. Yeah. He says, the truth is our problems are caused by dysfunctional and inappropriate political system and processes. And when he says that, I'm going to myself, wow. So he must know. He must know, Michael. So the thing is, choices. Joshua 24 says, before I say to you, I put before you life and death, make choices. So I am encouraging people. What are your closing words? Because we go for the break. When we come back, we are going to not be together. We have some guests that are coming in studio this morning. What are your closing words as you are encouraging people? And first thing, go out and vote. Exercise your franchise. What else
first
do you say?
First thing, indeed, go exercise that franchise that has been given to you. Mm-hmm. And of course, you know, let's get back to the quote we started with from Pastor Vance Havner of the U.S. long time ago. Life is a series of choices. And we're not just speaking politically now, because we need to understand this at a personal level, a family level, a community level. Life is a series of choices between the bad, the good, and the best. Everything depends on which we choose. And it would seem that in the long term, that if I choose badly, then is bad going to come of it? Mm-hmm. If I choose good, is good going to come of it? If I choose what is best for me, then I find myself in the center of the will of God, prospering and progressing in ways that I couldn't even imagine. And when that's done individually and then embraced corporately, in other words, as many of us as possible, holding on to this value and taking that as a mantra for life, then we'll find ourselves moving in the right direction and moving away from the path that imploded societies like Rwanda and Eritrea and Somalia took.
Yeah.
So we beg you, if you're listening today, please understand that it's your choice that will determine if we can be alive as a nation, successfully so, progressively so, prospering in that regard. It is our choices, even though in the final analysis, God is the one who, of course, is the author behind the scenes, writing this book of life on us. Mm-hmm. He has given us the ability to choose our chapters as we go along.
Yeah. All right. So we choose. We must choose. Go down, vote, choose. Integrity, honesty, righteousness, justice. Those are words. Whoever your local representative, if that's what it represents, go out and choose. But go out and vote. Because not voting, you have made a choice. Mike, thank you very much for being with us this week. Very good commentary, very good words of wisdom. Bless you. Hope to see you soon. All right, yes, blessings to you. Thank you very much. It's now 8:03 as we go for 8 o'clock break. Bye. Blessings. Bye-bye.
Best 100 FM, broadcasting live in all 14 parishes. Hanover 100.5, 100.9. St. James 100.9. Trelawney 100.3, 100.9. St. Anne 100.3, 100.5, St. Mary 100.5, West Milan 100.1, 100.5, St. Elizabeth 100.1, 100.5, Manchester 100.1, 100.5, Clarendon 100.1, 100.5, 100.9, St. Catherine 100.5, 100.9, St. Andrew 100.5, 100.9, St. Thomas 100.5, and 100.9. Bess FM, giving you the better vibe.
Best FM 100 on your dial. Keep listening.
Hello, I'm Roisin Hasty with the BBC News. The Albanian Parliament has approved a controversial deal that will see migrants who'd been trying to get to Italy brought to Albania to have their asylum claims processed. Two centres will be set up to hold 3,000 migrants in total at a time. Albania's Prime Minister Edi Rama signed the deal with his Italian counterpart Giorgia Meloni in November. Here's Guy Delaunay.
MPs took just 7 minutes to ratify the agreement for Albania to allow Italy to operate asylum facilities on Albanian territory. 77 voted in favour, with none against. But opposition MPs boycotted the vote. They'd claimed the deal violated Albania's sovereignty. The Constitutional Court ruled otherwise, allowing the vote to go ahead. Rights organisations have criticised the arrangement. Amnesty International described it as shameful.
Japan's main stock market hit a record high on Thursday. It returned to levels not seen since the Japanese asset bubble of the 1980s. The Nikkei 225 index surged amid optimism surrounding tech companies after the US chipmaker Nvidia posted even better profits than had been expected. Mariko Oi reports.
It's been more than 34 years since the Nikkei hit its previous record high, but less than 3 years after that peak, the stock index lost almost 60% of its value. But unlike last time, company earnings are strong. Global investors have also been shifting their money away from China, where its economy has been slowing down, to Japan. A huge part of this rally is also the weakness of its currency, the Japanese yen, which boosts exporters' shares because it makes their products cheaper in overseas markets.
A court in Spain has sentenced the Brazilian footballer and former Barcelona star Dani Alves to 4.5 years in jail for rape. He was convicted of assaulting a woman in the toilet of a Barcelona nightclub in December 2022. Guy Hedgeco has this report.
The jail sentence is much less than the 12-year term the victim's lawyers had been calling for. Because he has already served around a quarter of his sentence, Alves could soon be able to apply for prison leave. The court said that Alves's decision to pay the victim €150,000 in damages, regardless of the outcome of the trial, had been a mitigating circumstance in his sentence. Alves's lawyer has said his client will appeal.
X, formerly known as Twitter, has admitted to taking down accounts and posts related to the ongoing farmers' protests in India on the orders of the federal government. The platform said it disagrees with the action and that the move amounts to curtailing freedom of expression. It also stated it had launched legal action against the orders. India's government is yet to respond to X. You're listening to the latest world news from the BBC. Three people have died after a cargo ship collided with a bridge in southern China, causing several vehicles, including a bus, to plunge into the water. There's now a large gap in the Lishansha Bridge in Guangzhou, with an empty container ship lodged in the bridge opening. The ship's captain and owner have both been detained. The authorities say they're investigating the cause of the collision. China says it signed agreements to send pandas to a zoo in San Diego on the United States West Coast, signalling a new chapter in Beijing's use of so-called panda diplomacy. More from our Asia-Pacific editor, Celia Hatton.
For decades, Beijing loaned the bears as a sign of goodwill.
It's the only country in the world to have a native giant panda population. But in recent years, Beijing declined to extend the loan periods for pandas in the U.S. and other Western nations. Now, as relations improve, pandas will be sent to San Diego and to the Spanish capital, Madrid. Talks are also underway to send the bears to Washington, D.C. and Vienna.
6 days after Moscow announced the death in prison of the opposition leader Alexei Navalny, another leading dissident has urged Russians not to give in to gloom and despair. Speaking from his Siberian jail, Vladimir Karamurza said Russians owed it to their fallen comrades to continue to fight for democracy. He said he had no doubt Russia would one day become a normal, free European country. Google is pausing its AI-powered image generation tool after inaccurate illustrations of historical figures went viral on social media. The tech giant's Gemini chatbot has been accused of overcorrecting images to make them more diverse, even when doing so was historically inaccurate. A much-cited example included a picture of America's founding fathers, which turned up women and people of colour. Google says it will release an improved version soon. BBC News.
Grandpa, where are you going?
But see ya, I have business down by JPS and I need Stephen to take me. I'm going to see what I owe and pay.
You don't have to leave the yard, Pops. Just call 888-225-5577.
You mean if you tell me, say, me not have to wait in line anymore?
We have recognized the number that you are calling from as being attached to account number 301842.
Watch ya! How them get me new number? How them know it's me?
Grandpa, I registered your account. So when you call from this phone, JPS already knows you and then just give you the information.
Look where me live, Fissy. Thank God for you, young people.
For a better choice in all your electrical supplies, A, authorized 3M dealer and better brand names, B, better service including free island-wide delivery, C, all major credit and debit cards accepted. It's ABC Electrical Sales, shop number 8, Hagley Park Plaza, Kingston 10, open Monday to Friday, 8 a.m. to 5 p.m., Saturday, 8 a.m. to 4 p.m. We make your electrical jobs as easy as ABC. Call 754-3825-8 or fax 754-3659. ABC Electrical Sales, for a better choice.
Do you need reliable health care? We have it!
Yes, we do! Great George Street Pharmacy, shop number 897 Great George Street, Savannah Lamar, West Midlands. Opening hours, Mondays to Saturdays, 8:30 a.m. to 6 p.m. Call us at 876-603-7372 or WhatsApp us at 876-205-0499. Yes, we have reliable health care for you at Great George Street Pharmacy, Savannah Lamar.
The following is a paid announcement by the Jamaica Labour Party.
The Jamaica Labour Party is building a healthier Jamaica for us all. This means more doctors, more nurses, more hospital beds, more diagnostic equipment, and more health centres. This means more access to healthcare for all Jamaicans. It also means shorter waiting times, less medical bills, more smiles, and more lives saved. Join us in building a healthier nation. The Jamaica Labour Party, building for you and your community.
This election day, vote Jamaica Labour Party.
The proceeding was a paid announcement by the Jamaica Labour Party.
February is Reggae Month, and Best FM is catching the rhythm with Roots Kaleidoscope. Every week, we join the Reggae Open University from 6 to 7:30 p.m. Tune in for the latest in music. Meet the icons. Celebrate with us. Catch the rhythm on Best during Roots Kaleidoscope.
Best 100 FM is the authentic voice of Jamaica. Promoting your prosperity with better vibes and better music. Let us promote your goods and services for you. Advertise with us. For more information, call our office at 876-276-8935. That's 276-8935.
half a tree, one and drive, half a tree. Bossy, how you do a tech taxi style?
Jano, I want to tell you, say, at 2 months now, my transmission mash up, you know, and I check everybody and can't hear nothing positive.
Yeah, hear me? Yeah, waste all that time a shop around and never call the experts. Winters are to have them. Them have over 35 years of experience and them diagnose the problem and get back your transmission brand new. For them service excellent and efficient. Trust me, man. Yeah, hear me? Call them at 929-7040 or go to them at 106 Maxfield Avenue, Kingston 13 and talk directly to the boss. Just tell them I'm me, senor.
You big star. Yeah, man. Respect my boss.
Yeah, try and call him, because trust me.
Auto spares and repairs. Good afternoon.
Ah, what a relief.
It's good. It's better. But nothing beats.
Good morning. Welcome back to the Morning Connection. As I'd indicated to our callers, we're going to start taking our calls at after 9 this morning because we have to guests online that we're going to be talking to. Online, I have Mrs. Anika Watkis Porter. Good morning, Miss Porter. How are you?
Good morning to you. How are you? I am doing so very well. I'm so happy to be here. Thank you so much.
Oh, wow. And just so we know who we are speaking to, I just bit on your bio. You are an entrepreneur, a corporate podcast host, a producer, a coach, an international speaker, and you're host of the Entrepreneurial You podcast and TV show. And I'm looking at this. You have interviewed Les Brown, Richard Branson from that's Virgin Atlantic, John Lee Dumas, Paul Carrick Branson, and some other people. But you're having an event this weekend that you're hoping that we'll be able to join you. All right? So tell us about that.
Absolutely, Mr. Palmer. Thank you so much for giving us this opportunity. As we mentioned in my bio, I've been a speaker, I'm a podcaster, and overall you say a communicator. That's what it is, essentially. You know, getting the message out, making sure that others get their message out as well. And so we thought it important that, and by we, I'm speaking of three powerful communicators. Thelma Porter, versus known Thelma as, you know, if you've been in the broadcasting field, then you know Thelma Porter has been around as a broadcaster for some time. She's a certified public speaking coach, English speaking tutor, news presenter, all of that. And, of course, we have corporate communication specialist executive Winston Callum and myself, who are both, we're all organizers and presenters at this workshop. So we're looking forward to having a great day. We are all about highlighting the importance of effective communication in the workplace. It is absolutely necessary that, and not just in the workplace, in your business, your place of business as well. It is absolutely important that we not only speak, but we speak in a way, whether it's through verbal communication or nonverbal communication, that those who we're speaking to, that they completely understand what it is that we're saying. And the message that we intended to go out is actually going out the way that we want it to go out. So it's very important that, you know, we get it right, because it first starts there in terms of getting to closing business deals, in terms of, you know, engaging with your stakeholders, both internally within your workplaces, your businesses, and externally, in your homes, in your community, in your churches, wherever it is that you find your sphere of influence that you have to see, that you have to get your message across. And that's pretty much just about everybody, because we all communicate one way or another.
So that's interesting.
Go ahead, get your word in.
That's because I know you could go on and on because you specialize in that. But you have mentioned a whole lot of people. I'm going to throw one in at you. So do you think we are in the throes of an election campaign and there's a lot of communication that's happening? Do you think they're getting their message out? What do you think?
Oh, absolutely. Absolutely, they're getting their message out. Is it going out in a way that is intended is another story. But guess what? I am not here to judge that.
but they are communicating. Whether the message is reaching the person they are communicating to is another question.
The decoding and the encoding and all of those technicalities, which Thelma Porter herself, you know, will talk about. That's our area of expertise. This is looking into the nuances, the technicalities of communication, because indeed there are technicalities. It's not just, because, you know, we all of us are able to speak. Those of us who can speak, because there are persons who were not born with that ability.
Right.
But even if they can't speak, they sign, they project their bodies in certain way, you know, that will communicate a message. So
I understand what you're saying, because as the parent of somebody who is deaf and hard of hearing, they communicate a lot with their hands and their body and their faces, but they get a message across. And that's so very, very important. So, all right. So master your communication is the workshop. Is it a workshop or is it a seminar?
It is a workshop. It is a workshop.
So, and that's different from a seminar. Because a workshop, you actually go and do some work and learn some skills and that kind of a thing.
Yes, you're coming to work. You're coming to work. You know, you're going to have some case studies, some, you know, breakout sessions and so on, just to make sure that we're not just speaking as our participants. You know, we're engaging them in a way that is wholesome, fulsome, that they can, at the end of the workshop, walk away with technical, practical skills to level up, as we say, level up, yeah?
So this is a part of the lifelong learning that everybody needs to be doing. So your target market is everybody. Anybody who wants to learn how to master their communication, and they should come out.
Yes, it's for everybody, right? But particularly those who have to get the message out on behalf of their companies or their businesses, mm-hmm. right? Anybody, the information is going, and the learning is going to be applicable to everyone. But we're particularly zoning in on those who are, you know, they're stakeholders within their organization, and they have to get their word out. They are critical points within their organizations and their businesses, and they're interested in public speaking.
Okay.
You know?
All right. So let's master your communication. So you are going to be focusing on what? There are three eras that are on your poster.
Right.
So it's amplify your communication with podcasting. Tell us a bit about that. That's
absolutely. So I am the Jamaican podcast queen.
Who give you that title? You give yourself that title or?
Self-proclaimed because of when I started podcasting in 2017, hardly anybody in Jamaica was podcasting or even knew what that meant. Mm-hmm. And so when I started, I became an evangelist. I was on TV, radio.
You were preaching the gospel of podcasting?
I was, and I continue to preach the gospel according to podcasting. Yes.
Let me ask you something about podcasting. I'm always curious. Is it a way, part of the blue economy in terms of earning from it? Do you earn from podcasting?
Oh, you earn. You absolutely earn, because I'm not in this because, you know, for the love of it only.
Okay.
I'm involved in podcasting because it helps me to pay my bills.
Okay.
Through advertising.
Right.
Through advertising on the podcast. I've grown my podcast so in such a way that I attract advertisers. I do masterminds. I coach. I have the book podcast, Power the Quick Start Guide to Launching and Living Up Your Brand.
You're also an author. So do you remember those books that tell me the books that you've written.
So the book that I mentioned, I'm a 7-time author, but the book I've just mentioned is Podcast Power,
right.
Quick Start Guide to Launching and Living Up Your Brand. And certainly, in addition to the book, I also do Done For You podcasting. So, first of all, listening and they think, you know what, I want to start a podcast, but I can't bother. Here is where I come in. So, I'm going to be focusing on not teaching you how to podcast necessarily, because that's a whole other course that I do,
mm-hmm.
but to teach you the fundamentals of podcasting, why you should consider podcasting, and even some insights on if it is that you've started or want to start, some insights on how to do interviews properly.
Wow.
And things to consider when doing interviews.
All right. So that's you. And then there is Winsome.
Yes, Winsome is talking. I mean, as a communication specialist and public, the fundamentals of business communication, rather, is what she's going to be looking at, identifying and reaching out to target audiences, brand reputation management, how you communicate in a crisis, because don't we know,
about
there are always crises.
Yes, right. And she's a communications executive with one of our bigger organization, yes, with JPSCO. We know her from that because she's been, right, on our program. I'm talking about, right, the thing, right?
Absolutely, absolutely. And there are many, we know that there are many crises,
right,
that, you know, they've had to manage. And every workplace, every corporate entity does have, and in your business and in your daily life, there's a lot of crises that you always have to be leveraging and managing and trying to communicate the best way so that all the stakeholders, mm-hmm, they get the message, but at the same time, you do it in with clarity, and you do it in a way that you're not compromising one side versus the other.
Okay.
So that is absolutely critical.
And then there is build your confidence, connect with your audience, and that is being done by?
That's Thelma Porter, right? Famous broadcaster, mm-hmm, you know, public speaking specialist and coach. She's going to be getting into the technicalities of it now, the techniques to do this thing effectively, your gestures and your confidence and overcoming stage fright and how you, you know, not be nervous. And ultimately, how do you connect with your audience? How, okay, do you connect with your audience? It is key.
Okay. So where is this going? Where is this happening, Mrs. Watkins Porter? Where is this?
So thank you for asking. I'm glad you asked. So this is happening at the Exim Bank. That's 85 Hope Road, Exim Bank, 85 Hope Road, at 9 a.m. You may be seeing, well, 9 a.m. Mm-hmm. to 4 p.m. The 9 a.m. we're starting with the formalities, the registration, the about us, all those little things are getting out of the way because we're starting promptly, mm-hmm, at 10 a.m. Mm-hmm. And we are so excited. Lunch is included in the investment, a mere investment of $27,500. Mm-hmm. Lunch is included in that, in addition to break and an awesome day of learning. Mm-hmm. We have a few spots left, and so we are saying to you right now, just leverage this opportunity. Do not wait. Sign up right here, right now at bit.ly, that's bit.ly/communicationsmastery. Mm-hmm. That's bit.ly/communicationsmastery.
And how can they contact you if they want some more information? Give us your numbers, please.
Glad you asked as well. It's at 876-849-2571. That's 876-849-2571. I don't want to give too many numbers just to you know, to crowd and so the memory gets cluttered. So 876-849-2571, HennikaWatkins-Porter@gmail.com. Or, of course, you can go directly to bit.ly/communicationsmastery. We'd be happy to help you with the process. Give us a call, and we get it going. We see you on Saturday bright and early for a full day of learning. Come energized. Come with an open mind. Come ready to amplify and master your communication.
Wow. That's a mouthful what you have said. So if you want to master your communication, happening this Saturday at the Exim Bank, 85 Hope Road, from starting at 9 o'clock with registration, starting promptly in terms of the workshop at 10 o'clock, 10 to 4 o'clock. It is Master Your Communication with Miss Henika Watkins Porter, Winsome Callum, Thelma Porter.
And no relation, so let me say that. No relation.
Oh, you're not married into the family or anything like that.
No relations at all.
And you're going to be focusing on amplify your communication with podcasting, fundamentals of business communication, that's Winsome, and then build your confidence, connect with your audience, that's Thelma Porter. And that is it for now. Thank you very much for joining us. Yeah. We look forward to hearing about it. But if I never had two marriages doing on the weekend, and I'd have come because I want to learn how to do podcasting. So I'm going to have to talk to you otherwise in regards to it. But thank you very much, Mrs. Porter, for joining with us this morning on The Morning Connection. When we come back after the break,
thank you. And thank you for letting me quickly put in. Thanks for the opportunity to share about this workship. I don't want to leave that. I want to express or regret you for that. Thank you so much.
No problem. When we come back, we're going to be joined in studio with JPS Cares with Mrs. Audrey Williams, who is a media and PR manager, going to join us to talk about JPS Go app, and she's waiting to come into studio with me. I call her Miss Sunshine. So I'm going to come back after our break at 8:30 and I'd ask you for a song. So I want to go in that song, Emancipation song, if you can hit it as we go into the break at 8:30. When we come back at 8:30, we're going to be joined by JPS Cares by Mrs. Audrey Williams, our media and PR manager, who's going to be talking about how good JPS Go is when you use their app.
Sold I to the merchant ships. Minutes after they took I from the bottomless pit. But my hand was made strong by the hand of the Almighty. We forward in this generation triumphantly. Won't you help to sing these songs of freedom? 'Cause all I ever have, redemption songs, redemption songs. Emancipate yourselves from mental slavery. None but ourselves can free our minds. Have no fear for atomic energy.
Grandpa, where are you going?
But see ya. I have business down by JPS and I need Stephen to take me. I'm going to see what I owe and pay.
You don't have to leave the yard, Pops. Just call 888-225-5577.
You mean to tell me, say, me not have to wait in line anymore?
We have recognized the number that you are calling from as being attached to account number 301842.
Watch ya. How them get me new number? How them know it's me?
Grandpa, I registered your account. So when you call from this phone, JPS already knows you and then just give you the information.
Look where me live, Fissy. Thank God for you, young people.
Half a tree, half a tree. 100, 200.
Ready, mama. Ready.
Is this the confusion you feel when trying to work your way through medical systems in Jamaica? Try a dose of Ask Dr. Mary every Thursday at 5 to 6 p.m. Let Dr. Mary help you understand your medical problems and bring you to a calmer place.
What should a taxi service do for you? On-time taxi service is more than just a ride to the other side of town. They offer clean and spacious vehicles, reliable service, and promise to always look out for their customers. They'll come when you call and take you where you want to go on time.
We are something special on the road.
Yo, Dave, where did you get your water tank from? Multi-plastics tanks a lot. Oh, yeah, I heard they're selling cutting-edge water tanks. Let me find my way to 37 South Road or call them at 876-968-6657 now.
Vegem Printers for all your printing needs. We specialize in calendars, flyers, brochures, and more. Call us today at 968-7506. That's 968-7506. Or visit us at 4 East Bloomsbury Road off Hagley Park Road. Vegem Printers, your best choice in printing.
For all your Honda Ridgeline parts in Kingston, call 326-7371 or 821-5232 now. We sell genuine shocks, power steering pumps, engine mount, fender liner, strut mount, front end parts, engine parts, electrical switches and sensors, and many, many more. Remember, we are your Honda Ridgeline parts dealer located in Kingston. Contact us now at 326-7371 or 821-5232 for more detail.
The Morning Connection is not your usual talk show. We aim to stimulate discussion and chart new paths to self-empowerment. So please join us, Minette and Percy, on The Morning Connection, Mondays to Thursdays, 6 a.m. to 10 a.m. on Best 100 FM.
It's good, it's better, but nothing beats.
Good morning, welcome back. And I have in studio with me, it's my pleasure to have Mrs. Audrey Williams, who is the PR and media manager for JPS Co. You know, we normally carry the feature JPS Cares, and she's in studio with me. Welcome, Miss Audrey. Welcome, Miss Sunshine. How are you?
I am very well, thank you. How are you?
I am very good. I look forward to seeing her. I've known her for some time, but she always is just lights up the room. So if you see it shining brightly in here, it is because I have sunshine to make me warm outside. Coley,
it is cold. I was thinking, and I wasn't going to bother with a jacket, and I was like, maybe I will bother. Yeah, I'll bother.
Yeah, so all right. So what's up?
Well, we want to help our customers, as always.
Yes.
To make their lives more convenient. And everybody, boy, I don't know if there was ever a time in life when people are busy and don't have time, it's now.
Right.
I don't know. When I was a child, I don't think people were this busy. Although, what would I know as a child?
No, some of us were very conscious as children. So
yeah, true.
I was just reminded in Black History Month, I was very conscious. I was exposed to Pan-Africanism by my older brother, who was in Rastafarian. So very conscious grade three.
Yes.
I was about 8 or 9, and I went to a Catholic primary school.
Okay.
And I had a white nun, and she said, mm-hmm. Go and move that. I said, I'm not moving on. You know, white person that run me around the place. So
wow.
I was out of order. And
you were what, about 7? Because that's grade 3.
Yeah, 7 or 8. Yeah, man. And I'm saying, no. But you know, some of us were very conscious.
Conscious.
I remember that experience, yeah.
Yeah, no, you know, awareness. And I soon come to this, but I just want to make the point. Self-awareness, I don't know where it comes from, mm-hmm. per se, but... Well, from you, in your case, it would have been your brother. You know, he would have sort of. But I remember even in high school. Mm-hmm. So back then, like, wearing your hair natural was something that you just never did.
Right.
Like, it was a rite of passage when you got to 10 or 11, and sometimes before, that you were going to cream your hair and it was going to be straight, bone straight. God forbid that you had even a little toops of natural hair, because something is wrong with that.
You'll be... But you worked all that time, even then?
No, I didn't. And it just occurred to me out of the blue, without anybody saying anything to me or so. Like, but what's wrong with my hair, though?
Oh, wow.
Like, why do I have to be in such a big hurry
to get to your cream?
Like every 3 months at the time. It was every 3 months, you
yes,
know?
Sir.
And the only people who never creamed them hair was either Rasta or Pentecostal, or had a medical condition so they couldn't, you know, manage the cream.
Right.
And I said to myself, but what really wrong with it, though? Like, did God make, like, a whole set of people where something just seriously wrong with them, you know?
Mm-hmm.
And I began to just look into it and say, no, but I think I could wear my... And then, of course, the thing was, you can't wear it out. You can't, this, you can't, that. But that is for a whole different conversation.
Okay, because we're talking about...
I digress. But on the point of awareness, I want y'all to be very aware.
Mm-hmm.
That there are ways to make your life easier. So I want to talk a little bit. I know I had touched on it already last week, but I'm going to start with it and then move into other things.
Right, when you and Solita was with us, yes.
Yes, and I hope
I met
she's
Solita
listening.
For the first time. I'm going, oh, wow.
I know, like, she's a real person,
yes,
right?
Yes, right. I thought she was
not AI. AI. No, I don't have any AI in the department.
No, but interesting, you talk about AI because the basis of this app is artificial intelligence.
That is correct. That is correct. So we can't get away from it completely, but Solita is real. So
She's very real. She's very, very real.
So one of the things we want people to do is to use the mobile app, mm-hmm. and we have now about 3/4 of our customer base now has the ability to use the app.
Actually, everybody
has the ability to use the app. But right. in terms of what I'm about to tell you, 3/4 right. would. So our customer base is roughly 680,000 customers.
Yes.
That is customers. Remember, say one customer might have a whole household of people and so on.
Right.
But we have 680,000 customers and we have about 520,000 smart meters out there.
Okay.
Which means that those people can use the added benefits in the app. The app is for everybody. Everybody can view them bill. Everybody can pay them bill. Everybody can, you know, report an outage and all kind of other things. But what I'm about to tell you about is something that you can do if you have a smart meter.
Which is 520,000 people.
That's right. And a lot of people.
That's a lot of people.
Yes, it is. So in terms of your usage, now some people at the end of the month, they go, oh my gosh, how did this happen?
Right. And you pointed that out last time.
We don't want that. Exactly. We don't want that.
You can track your
usage. So you want to track your usage. Go in the app, right? Don't just use it for bills. Go in the app and on the home page where you might see welcome John or welcome
I managed to say I went on it on my computer.
Yeah, because of course there is the laptop version, which is the same thing. The web application can be on your laptop or on your phone.
Smartphone. And everybody has smartphones. Some people have 2-3 smartphones.
I'm telling you,
like even the children.
Super smart people.
That's what it is.
I think I just only
have one phone. Or it is to show off. I have a phone for the digital and on for flow or whatever. No, I just use one phone now.
And you can put your two SIMs in one,
if you have a two SIM phone.
Yeah, if you have a two SIM phone.
Mm-hmm.
So on that page, you're going to see in the box that has your name, say your name, John Brown.
Yes.
In that box, you will see a little yellow box that says view more. That, guys, is where you're going to tap to get into the usage. People say, I don't know how to do it. That is where you do it. Right there where it says view more, you go into it, and then you're going to see some options. You're going to see billing, you're going to see usage, you're going to see budget. Usage is where you want to go, because that now is going to give you a clue as to not just what's happening at the end of the month, but what's happening like last week, what was happening day before yesterday, because you can go to daily and you can even go to hourly.
So that tracking.
Is a huge, yes, that is a huge, huge benefit.
Wow.
So when you get into the space, you're going to see your regular chart, whatever that you're normally seeing
right.
on
I've
your
seen
bill.
That. Right.
But if you look to the right, the top right of the chart, where it says monthly, if you tap on that, you're going to see options. And I'm going to, this is now for the benefit of those who are actually viewing, because, you know, media is so merged now. So we're on radio, but we're on YouTube.
Right.
So guys, I'm just giving you this example.
Are you showing
I'm going
to
turn this around. So you see the chart and you see at the top right where it says monthly.
Mm-hmm.
All right. When you tap on that, you're going to see options for monthly, weekly, daily,
or
hourly.
Are you kidding me?
Exactly.
So that is what so that's what it does for us now.
Right. So now you can choose. I hope I'm angling my phone right. Now you can choose. All right, I want to see weekly. Or I want to see daily. Or I want to see hourly. Suppose you lock up your house and you're gone. Like,
gone somewhere.
Only the fridge plug in. Everything plug out. And when you look, you see, for hourly, some serious things are going on.
What happened?
Who visit my house? You have to say.
Who visit your house? That's what they say.
You have to say, didn't you say you were going to school?
Uh-oh.
Didn't you say you were going to be in school?
Are you serious?
So you're going to have to, that way now, you can really drill down.
Yes.
And if you look below the chart, you will see current consumption, but you'll also see projected consumption. So this will give you an idea, meaning the rate at which you presently are going. If you keep it up,
what are going to be your bill going to look
this
like?
Is what it's
going to
look like by the time your billing date is here.
Okay.
Now you can decide if that's okay. Like, oh, all right, no problem. All
right.
Or
so,
I don't like this.
So we go into the JPS. I'm on the web page thing now, and I'm at.
So you want to go to usage.
So go to the usage there.
Right.
And then it tells me, let me see now.
So you're seeing your current consumption and you're seeing your projected consumption.
Okay.
This account has a smart meter?
I'm not sure.
Okay. Okay. No problem. So if it has a smart meter, you would see, I cannot see so well from here. So.
right.
Okay, fine. See there? So
your current consumption.
You're at this.
current.
Now,
if you continue at this rate.
Right. But projected, this is where you
so will. So you can end know up. Much your bill going to end up at
right.
February 23rd.
And you can say, all right, yeah, that's all right. Or, let me see if I need to do some, you know, amendment to my activities.
Wow. Amazing.
Yeah.
So
yeah.
you can control it.
You
and
can.
Then one of the new features.
And you're not to surprise.
And one of the new features that you have is that you have prepaid, where you put down the money.
Exactly. And prepaid is wonderful because that is like total control. You decide, I'm going to spend X, $10,000 for the month. Whatever.
Right. And you put it on.
You put it on.
Yes.
And then you are able to track and say, all right, this is how much you have left. And you have people who use it in different ways. You know, like they say, all right, I'm going to wash my clothes.
Yes.
So I'm going to plug out the X. While
right.
Now, when we're on postpaid, we're not really thinking about them someday. You just
I'm on postpaid. That's the challenge.
Do your thing. Yes, do your thing. But people on prepaid tend to be that much more sensitive. So they're going to see where they're doubling up. They're like, it's not just a matter of lights, you know, guys. Because let me tell you something. Big hint. Lights are not the biggest part of your bill.
No, the fridge.
It's the part that you see kind of more obviously, but the
refrigerator
the in the average household is like 60% of your bill.
So
remember,
you
plug in all day, you know, all day, all night, 24 hours a day for the entire 30 days. So it is a big cooling equipment.
Right.
So the big coolers and the big heaters.
Which is like the iron?
Not even so much the iron.
The
electric
dryers.
Stove. Oh, the dryers are brutal. The dryers are like,
They just near up holy puff electricity.
But the thing about the dryer, you don't really have to use the dryer all that regular.
Can you have sunshine?
So it's just like when you have like maybe a couple of days back to back of rain and you just can't get to dry your clothes, you might just do like a 1-2 load. Or you have some people that are like, you know what? I don't care. I like my dryer because it makes my towels fluffy.
Uh-oh.
And that's fine. Because guess what?
I just pay for it at the end of the month.
But you work, and you must know if you want your towel fluffy and nice.
Oh, the towel fluffy and nice. So what you're saying, okay, just to recap quickly. So you go into the app, you see the bill, and then you see usage. You can go into the usage, and you can get usage monthly.
Monthly, weekly, daily, hourly.
Are you serious?
Yeah, man, it is that good. It is that good. That's what you call good news.
that's good
so,
news. So you are able to track it. And
if you go
prepaid, like you say, okay, this is what I put in my budget to spend. And as you were saying, that some people, all right, I'm going to be pressing our thing, I'm gonna plug out that.
Right, exactly. Depending on how you wanna roll. Some people are like, I'm not about that. Like, really don't.
It's all right. When they burn them pocket at the end of the month.
Yeah. And when it come, when it done. And you have people who live like that. And we're not even here to say, oh no, don't do that. We're just here to say
that JPS don't care.
We care. But we understand that people have different goals and different values.
Yeah, right.
Because for some people, they really value the ability to just maybe chill back and run this, run that, eat some nachos, watch a movie. Don't bother me because I work hard. I deserve this moment. And that's fine.
That's fine. But you will pay.
For somebody else, they value something else. They're like watching every dollar and they're da-da-da-da. And they value that. And that's fine too. So we're here to support you in whatever way works for you.
JPS collapse all the way to the bank when it would depend on your lifestyle.
No, man, because if the people them get vexed and mad at us and da-da-da, we're not really laughing. We're like, oh, man, we try to tell you.
I like what you're doing. You're giving people the tools. So with this smart business, talking about choices.
Exactly.
We're talking about
you have choices, and we don't really want to tell you which choice because you know what feels good and you know what you work hard for.
Right.
So we just want to say, no man, here are the tools that you can use, and whatever works best for you and makes you happy and fulfilled, we applaud you and we are here to support you in your lifestyle.
Okay.
Yes.
Okay.
So now, on a quicker note,
because
I will go fast now.
Yes.
I'm sorry, I'm making all these noises. You can also, one of the things you can do with the app is you can open an account. So some people feel like they have to come into the office and take a day off from work and all them something there. But you don't have to do all of that. You can say, you could say right here in this seat in the studio and open an account. Let us say you are
moving
house.
What do you need to open an account?
Right. So you're going to have your documents. You're going to just have those ready. Because when you're going through, you know, if you stop figure, get that and stop figure. Mm. So let's just get all our documents
together. So what
you
need together. To open an account?
An ID. Right. One of three government IDs. Your driver's license, your passport, or your voter's ID.
Right.
You need your TRN.
Yes.
You need to write and sign a letter requesting service.
Right.
And you need proof of ownership if it is your place.
Ordered.
If it's your place, you need your title or your property tax receipt.
Okay.
Or if you just buy it, an attorney's letter or from the developers, that will work as well.
Mm-hmm.
If, however, it's not your property, you are now a tenant of somebody else's property,
right.
Then you want a letter from the landlord
I'm giving this person permission.
Please go ahead and give them an account there. Because all kind of things happen out there.
Yes, right.
And so now that you have all of your things. Oh, and if it is a place that, say, it just expanded or just whatever, you're going to need that certificate because it will need to be certified. So you need the government electrical regulator's certificate. That's what you get from the Ministry of Energy. So now that you have all these things, you take a picture of each individual thing so that when it comes time to upload them, you just easily go into your pictures and upload them.
So that means I just take a picture.
Mm-hmm.
You have a WhatsApp number I can send it to, or just...
No, you're going to do it in the app, in the wonderful app. Yep.
Wow.
Yes. So you go into your app. You're again on the home page where it says, Hello, John.
Right.
And you tap at the bottom of your page, you will see a number of options. You'll see home, you'll see services, customer support.
Yes, I've seen that, yeah.
So you're going to go into services.
Yes, I see that.
Right. Now, when you go into services, you see there, new service,
stop service, upgrade service,
transfer service,
grid extension.
Right? So it's all there.
Right.
And it's very intuitive because all you have to do is tap on it and keep following the instructions.
And it says, how we serve you? It says exactly. New service, stop service, upgrade, transfer service.
That's right.
I'm having a ball here.
Yeah.
A grid extension service. So you just take that and you just send it to the different ones.
Exactly. So you just tap on your new service
and then
you follow it. It's as they like to say, intuitive. So it asks you for your class of service, like you want residential or you want commercial,
right.
Or you want temporary supply. Temporary supply is like you have one big bashment and you don't really want the supply for the whole time. You just want one little, like 1 day, 2 day, or you're in the construction business, you're putting up some townhouses or some whatever, and you need power for the time that you're going to be building, and then you're going to take away yourself. So that's temporary. Construction sites, mm-hmm. Big events, parties, whatever.
I mean, and it says, and interestingly, whether it's prepaid or postpaid, you
prepaid
can select
postpaid,
that.
You
and
can
how much
choose.
Meters you want.
Exactly. You might want a 1 meter, or two.
Oh, wow.
If it's a complex, you know, you're going to head for more and so on. So when you fill all of that out and you press continue at the bottom, then it's going to take you to the next page where you're going to give information about yourself. Let me just do a little pretend. I'm doing a pretend one so that I can go to the next page.
So the pretend services, let's talk permission.
I will dump it afterwards so then come try giving a new service.
Right.
So the next page now is applicant's information. And of course, all of that is known to you because it's your first name, your middle name, your last name, your TRN number, your mobile number. Put in your address where you're at and... Sorry, where you're going, where you want to be.
Right.
And are you the owner of the property? You're going to say yes or no. Mailing address is the same. Sometimes it is, sometimes it's not. Is there a meter there already? So hint now, guys. If there's a meter there already, it helps a lot if you can get the meter number. Sometimes you can't. It's like, you know, you just can't. But if you can, then that's great because it makes it a little easier in terms of the processing and so on. Once you fill out all that information, you go to the next page where you're going to upload your information. This is a part now where they say, put in your information.
So you're going to put in your picture
of your ID, your picture of your TRN. If your driver's license is your ID, then you know it's both your ID and your TRN.
Oh, wow.
Because, you know, that's
so all
the
of that
number.
Is happening with the app.
Every last thing is happening right here. And so, all right, let me just put in some things so I can take us to the next page. I want people to see how this works. And so it's really very intuitive. People, instead of going into office and staying like the whole, you know, actually, I shouldn't even say the whole day because, that's another thing. I'm getting ahead of myself, but I'm going to give you a little like Rips. A sneak preview. Mm-hmm. So we're introducing some new systems in the office now.
Yes.
Where one time people used to come and say, Lord, I spend the whole day. Da, da.
No, you don't need to do that anymore. Okay.
So you can come. We have a new system now where it can, you can get through sometimes way faster, under an hour, sometimes even under half an hour, depending.
10 minutes, 20 minutes?
We're aiming for that. We're aiming for that.
Oh, wow.
Yeah, we're aiming for that because here's the deal. What we do every year is we do a customer
survey.
And the things that people say are distressing to them,
yes.
We'll say, all right, that's next on the list. So we're working our way
down. So this is how you've come up with this app?
Absolutely.
All of the things that you've built in the app.
Yeah. Absolutely. Mm-hmm. So let me try and get... Right. So continue. So once you give them all of the information, you get to your summary page where it basically tells you, so this is what you have said. Because, you know, people sometimes make mistakes.
Do you need to change, edit, that
yes.
kind of thing, right?
Because sometimes, you know, say your fingers slip and you write things where you never mean to write.
And finger them too big. Not thumbs, slim and nice
problems
like yours.
With thumbs.
Yes, you understand.
Oh, and I should point out there's a save and exit feature. So sometimes people reach to a point and
they forget something.
They realize, snap, but I don't have the exact address or, oh, I don't have the X or Y, whatever it is that they don't have.
You save it?
You can save it. Exit, come back and pick up where you left off because you don't have to start over from scratch.
That's great.
Yes.
That's a great feature.
And once you have, all right, time is running out. Let me just go fast. Once you have done all of that,
yeah.
you will see your number. So it'll say something like,
application number.
Your exactly.
And they give you an application number that is specific for
to you.
To me alone. So
that's
nobody's
right.
got that
you
number.
You won't have that number.
And then you track
so
it through
ever
the
need
system.
It for, exactly.
I just
you
keep
know
going.
What it's all about.
Yes, yeah, so I do. That makes sense. You know, I'm a bright boy, you know.
Yeah, I'm saying. So, you know, so you're able to track
it
straight
through the system
until
you get
the
service.
Your service. And you never have to go. In an office ever. So you can be on the beach, you can be in studio, etc. You can be in the supermarket line, like a line long, and just
and do all of that.
Yeah. So
and you get service. By the time they boom, you have service.
Okay, so just to say, it's not right away.
No, but what's turnaround time?
One to five business days. And sometimes people get it in less.
Oh, that's great.
Especially if there's a meter there already.
You're good. If you don't have a meter,
your
guaranteed
already,
service is 1 to 5 days
after application. After processing. So, yes, very important. So, sometimes this is the experience that some people have. They might do something and there is something incorrect
right.
with the application, or the picture wasn't clear, it's kind of fuzzy, or something like that. And they might get an email now saying your application was incomplete. And when they go into it, they say, your picture was unclear or something else,
whatever
it is. So you have to go back and fix that so that we can process it. So the processing of 1 to 5 working days is once your application has been processed,
everything
I would say,
is good.
Right.
So after it's been processed and they say good to go, then you can expect to get
your service
between 1 to 5 business days.
Right. That's
okay.
correct.
That's good.
Correct. So we're very happy about that. We
I'm very happy about that for other Jamaicans.
Yes.
I mean, I do have to go into the office to apply.
Exactly.
Oh, my Lord.
I know that some of our folks, they are very much into personal contact over the counter. And I get it.
That's all right.
Maybe
but some people,
the
young people,
business.
Them can't bother.
Young people are like, they're over that. But there's some people who really, 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 they need to eyeball a human being, and I get that because that's been their experience for their whole life, and there's a level of comfort they have with that. Them not sure said this newfangled something when you press send if it gone anywhere for true, if anybody really look on it.
All right.
But
my mom
have no fear.
My mom was 88, uses her phone and
big
WhatsApp and Netflix.
Nice.
So they are
yes.
becoming yes,
savvy. That's correct.
So
people are catching on and being very savvy. So
right.
we're very, very happy about that.
All right. So that's the app for you today. Is there anything you're telling us about?
Actually, I will just close off by saying, same way how you can open, you can close as well. So if it is that you are moving from the premises, you are, you know, going to somewhere else, you can close out without coming in. Same process. Go to the home page, and this time you're going to select stop service, and you just follow it. It's very intuitive, and basically you have your things ready, your TRN, your letter, and so on. Because you see, it's important for those things, you know, because we don't want anybody to be, as Jamaicans would say, a bad mind and come close your account for you. So we need to make sure. Say, are you really you?
Oh my Lord! You know, that's interesting. We were talking about choices, and my friend who is in Portland was saying to me, he went to some young people and saying, you're on a road going somewhere, and what is to prevent you? Mm-hmm. And all the children kept saying is bad mind. People prevent you from achieving your goals. So when they say bad mind, I had to laugh this morning. But that's all they could think about. They never took personal responsibility for their action in terms of the choices that they make.
That is crazy, because you know what? I had to say to somebody, I know I only have 2 minutes left, but it seems like as a society, we're obsessed with bad mind. Like, how much care we see on the car, bad mind, one hit me. I'm like, why are we obsessed with what other people are doing?
I am accountable for me, for my action, for my choices.
Let us focus on being our best selves.
Right. So
and growing as people.
That's what it is. So JPS Go cares,
yes,
is just we're talking about on being our best self on the app that you can download from Google
Play or the Apple Play Store.
Put it on your phone. You can apply for service. You can look for your usage. That I found that interesting, and I've heard somebody speak about the prepaid service that it has allowed them to save a whole heap of money.
In fact, what the research shows is that people who go prepaid typically see a reduction in their expense by up to 30%. And probably more too. And that is just the sensitivity and the
Because if you know only $10,000, you don't do everything. Because one of the things that we don't recognize is that our appliances, especially the fridges, are better eat a nyama of electricity. And if you can monitor that and watch what you're doing and plug out, you told me something interesting. I've started doing it. When something not in use, plug it out. Plug it out, and you'll see how it affects your electricity bill. So JPS Co. really does care
about you.
So thank you very much, Mrs. Audrey Sunshine Willing.
You're most welcome.
I was the manager of PR and media. That's what
it is. Yes, media and public relations. Yes.
In JPS, who has come kind of instituted us to share to see JPS Co. really cares about you by giving you this ad. And what I've discovered that you have been listening to your customers.
We're listening.
The consumers to your customers in terms of what they need to say. I can never forget that there's a difference between customers and consumers of JPS Co. So as we come up to our 9 o'clock break, I want to thank you for joining us in studio, and we hope to see you next week as you come back telling us about how JPS Co. really cares on Best 100 FM as we go to our 9 o'clock break. When we come back, we're going to be taking your calls in studio, so the lines will be open. And remember, it's 876-279-8473. Thank you very much.
Best 100 FM, broadcasting live in all 14 parishes. Hanover 100.5, 100.9. St. James 100.9. Trelawney 100.3, 100.9. St. Anne 100.3, 100.5. St. Mary 100.5. West Milan 100.1, 100.5. St. Elizabeth 100.1, 100.5. Manchester 100.1, 100.5. Clarendon 100.1, 100.5, 100.9. St. Catherine 100.5, 100.9. St. Andrew 100.5, 100.9. St. Thomas 100.5 and 100.9. Best FM, giving you the better vibe.
Simply the best. FM 100 on your dial. Keep
the following is a paid announcement by the Jamaica Labour Party.
Jamaican people, JLP say building time. Anything less, we now pay them no mind. Building for you and your community, we will build up Jamaica by supporting good policies. Yeah, build a better life for you and for me.
The proceeding was a paid announcement by the Jamaica Labour Party.
No, the water gone again. Yo, Dave, where did you get your water tank from? Multi-plastics tanks a lot. Oh, yeah, I heard they're selling cutting-edge water tanks. Let me find my way to 37 South Road or call them at 876-968-6657 now.
Vetron Print is for all your printing needs. We specialize in calendars, flyers, brochures, and more. Call us today at 968-7506. That's 968-7506. Or visit us at 4 East Bloomsbury Road off Hagley Park Road. Vetron Printers, your best choice in printing.
For all your Honda Ridgeline parts in Kingston, call 326-7371 or 821-5232 now. We sell genuine shocks, power steering pumps, engine mount, fender liner, strut mount, front end parts, engine parts, electrical switches and sensors, and many, many more. Remember, we are your Honda Ridgeline parts dealer located in Kingston. Contact us now at 326-7371 or 821-5232 for more detail.
The Morning Connection is not your usual talk show. We aim to stimulate discussion and chart new paths to self-empowerment. So please join us, Minette and Percy, on The Morning Connection, Mondays to Thursdays, 6 a.m. to 10 a.m. on Best 100 FM.
Good morning. Welcome back to The Morning Connection. We just had our feature, JP Oscar Cares, and before that, we just did a quick interview with Master Your Communication. That's happening this Saturday. Go out and learn some new skills in terms of what God's doing. 876-279-8473. As we come back to you, it's now 4 minutes after 9 o'clock. Our lines are now open for you to call in and tell us what you think. This morning we have been talking about choices, and we're looking at some of the choices we have made in terms of our personal responsibility that we have to ourselves. And as we come towards the end of this week, I wouldn't say solo this week, I've had online out of Portland my very good friend Michael Aiken, who has a wealth and knowledge of information and experiences which help us in terms of what we're looking at as we look towards our local government election that's going to be happening on Monday. Wow. The 26th day of February it is. And today, it was about 35,000 people will be voting today. That would be the security forces, election day workers will be voting today all across this nation. So, and the election day workers, which would be poll clerks, one day police, all of those people. Then, of course, our regular police force. And, of course, Army will be voting today. I remember, as Joshua said to the chairman of Israel, you need to make choices. And as we've been saying on this program, please go out and vote. 41% of persons polled had indicated that they would not interested in voting. That means there's 59% when you take into consideration very interested, 22 somewhat interested, 12 who ambivalent. So 59% of our population, that's over 2 million, a little over 2 million persons should be able to vote in these elections. Some people have dubbed it as a national election in a local level, and that's how it has happened. in terms of what we've been seeing on the ground, in terms of the leaders of both political parties out there, mass meetings. You think that we had a general election. Good morning, caller. Welcome to the Morning Connection. How are you?
Not bad, Pastor.
Hi, Mr.
Cruz.
Yes, Mr. Cruz. We just opened the lines for call. How you doing?
Not bad, man. Mm-hmm. Yeah. Well, no, Miss Minute come back, you know, but I hope when she come back, I don't go for the police, for the breakfast.
you mean JD's so urban punch?
If she no come back, you want now to go, but you really want her to come back.
Come on, she's going to come back, you know. Yeah. Where's Ipswich in relation to you, Mr. Cruz? Where's Ipswich in St. Elizabeth? Where is that?
What is
that? Where's Ipswich? Where's Ipswich? You are featured in the paper today. Where's Ipswich?
It's up Magachi side. I think up that side. When you go, Magachi. Wait.
Okay.
You know Magachi? Right.
Yeah, I know where Magachi is. Yeah, I know where Magachi is.
Around that side.
Okay, so Mugabe, Kilimanjaro. He says he'll retain Ipswich division. Interesting. Wow.
Yeah.
Yeah,
what we call about this morning, no, Pastor?
Mm-hmm.
What is it? How can Israel get away with so much crime and evil? I mean, I don't hear nobody in Jamaica like the major people and politicians or media condemn what they do. Why?
When they say, all right, you want them to make a statement about it. But I think I've heard different people. The PMP has joined in with South Africa in terms of the International Court of Justice. Yes.
Yeah, we always back those things, you know, PMP always do that. Be sure about that.
Right. So they,
I think it was last year. Mm-hmm. I think it was a PMP. I don't remember if it was the opposition leader talked something about Israel before they started this thing. Mm-hmm. But everybody expect this man to do what he's doing now.
You mean Netanyahu? Netanyahu, yeah. You're talking about?
Yeah, he may talk about that man is no Jew, he's not a Jew. White people are no Jew.
Okay, who white are Jews?
White people come from this earth, you know. White people is not from this earth.
Where they come from?
Fallen angel.
Oh, I see. No, Cruz, really now. So, for me personally, killing people the way that we see it happening is unacceptable. But then, they balance that out with what happened on October 7th.
No, Pastor, don't talk about
October 7th. No, hold on, man. But you are saying, hold on. We are talking about, you want to go back into history, but I'm saying, what has
preceded... No, Pastor, it's not history. Couple months before, the year before, 2 years before.
No, hold on.
Where Israel been doing bulldoze on people.
Hold on.
And run them off the land and kill them. October 7th is just a little...
Mr. Cruz, because everybody, so there are atrocities on both sides. Would you agree with that?
No, Pastor, there's no atrocity on
all
right,
both sides. So hold on a second. Mr. Cruz, you are giving an opinion, and I'm having a different opinion from you.
No, your opinion wrong, Pastor.
All right.
Mr. Cruz. Israel and America.
Mr. Cruz.
Pastor, this is almost like when they do a South Africa.
Mr. Cruz. Let us take it thing by thing. I'm saying... One life lost on either side is a life that is lost to me. You agree with me?
No, Pastor. If a person kill a person, the government hang them, and we prove saying kill a person,
right.
That is right.
All right. So what do you believe about war? Is there a righteous war that can be fought?
Yes, Pastor.
And tell me one of them that has happened in history in terms of people.
If the American can invade this country, we have a right to fight to it.
Okay. So, but we're talking about war generally, because nobody wins in war, you know. You know that?
Yeah, man. Somebody win. People win.
Okay. But in terms of people dying.
Unfortunate, the poor, poverty, third world colored people always lose in a war.
Okay.
If you check history, the white man always come out on top until today. So me, I wonder if
have you
God
seen,
is a
have you
racist God.
Oh, no, he's not. He's not.
Then why allow white people to still rule the world so long, Pastor?
White people rule the world. So we talk about the Chinese and the Russians. The Chinese and the Russians are not people too?
Yeah, they're my people, but those people are fighting for them right over the centuries.
Okay.
But the white man, me attack the Caucasian, the white European, them were the evilest thing they don't come from this earth.
But you see, mister, but I think some of the times you go to extremes, because in my own thing, there's one race, one human race. So if
Pastor, there's no one human race. The white people are different from it.
Okay. Well, may I disagree. But what I'm saying, I disagree with you. And because I disagree with you, you're saying to me I'm wrong. And you say, can't hold that. Because we're trying to logically. All right. Okay, Mr. Cruz. Let us have it at that. I am wrong. You are right.
Yes.
All right, sir.
I'll live wrong.
All right, sir. All right, then.
Oh,
anything?
By the way,
What?
All those haters may hate me from the program. May I hear them?
They love you, man. I guess if somebody love you, you can't deal with love. Because you're so.
Especially that American speaking guy. I don't know if they deport him. Or
no, he's not. He's a Jamaican. He's a Jamaican.
No, what I'm saying, I don't know. He was in the American army and he
okay.
Come out here.
I don't know.
Pastor, did you know that most of the soldiers that was in the American army and they came home. They are spies. They send them home to spy.
You know, as I said to you, Cruz. Some of the time you say some things, right? Some of the time there's no basis for it, but you are entitled to your own opinion. So we can agree to disagree. I'll give somebody else another chance to call. All right?
Okay.
All right then, Cruzy. Remember, the lines are open for us to call. 876-279-8473. Go ahead. Have a call on. Good morning, caller. How are you?
Yeah, good morning.
How are you, my friend? What's up?
Yeah, good morning, Pastor.
Yeah, what's up? What's on your mind this morning?
Yeah. Pastor, I don't agree with this way I talk about certain things, you know.
That's all right. That's okay.
Yeah, man, imagine. Now, look here. Peace, justice, sir, right? Are you a pastor, right?
Mm-hmm.
And you say you can't render fire for fire, don't it?
Yeah.
You know?
Yeah, you are saying what I have said, right?
Listen, all right, listen now. About 1,200 people in Palestine and killed on Israel. I want you to face it, you know.
Mm-hmm.
1,200 people.
Mm-hmm.
I basically have to the man and land them at defend. And imagine say, not near killing nearly.
When you say land, okay. When you say land they are defending, what do you mean?
Oh, you mean they know Israel goes to take away the man in land and kill off the man in their land. But leave that now. Come on, sir.
Mm-hmm.
Come on, sir, now.
In a Jamaica, right? In a Jamaica, yeah.
Listen now, man. We said nearly 30,000 people not delicate, including 10,000 people.
Mm-hmm.
Come on, man. God Almighty, man. You have to put not there, man. Not there. You see, not there, man. If you catch a fire, I'm sorry because it's been a 1 million time, man. I have to, man.
Well, hold on.
I have to support them, man.
But I'm not supporting anything. Hold on. Did I? Cruz made a point, and I'm saying I categorically do not support people killing people. But that's what I said.
Yeah, but come like you don't want to be natural.
No, but I'm saying we are making it seem that one side is innocent. And I'm saying no sides are innocent in a conflict when people are dying. That's what I said, you know.
Look here, man. You're a pastor. My own is innocent. The Bible says you can't render evil for evil.
So, right, so in saying that.
All right, I can't tell you then, no. The Palestine NGO. Israel. Let me say them make a mistake. And God Almighty, man. Not now I kill out nearly 30,000 people, man.
But brethren, did you hear hello? Did you hear me saying that what the Israelis are doing is correct? I never said that.
Boy, I emphasize to the man then fear the man then man. I man and land, you know.
You see, in turn, my brother, my brother, but hold on, the history in that region did not begin in 1940. That's what a lot of people are missing out on. The history did not start in 1940. In terms of what we see happening in that.
From 1948, Israel, America, Canada, England, Canada.
Brethren, listen to what I'm saying. The history in that region did not begin in 1940 with the modern birth of Israel. Do you understand that? Do you? All right. No, I'm saying to you, do you understand that?
Yeah, man, I tell you, but if we are talking about them, about Israel, them man, I know Israel man, them man, I tell you, white boy.
Okay. All right, my brother. Okay. So you hear my position clearly though. So I don't want you to misconstrue what I have said, because the history. No, but I never said that. But I never said that, my brother. I never said that.
No, we can't be said sort of nonsense, man.
Okay then. Well, I did not say that.
You don't agree with the man,
I did. No, no, sir, no, sir, no, sir, no, sir. I'm saying no, no, no to the murder and slaughter of children, adults, or anybody on both sides. I'm saying no.
Man, it's me catching 10 million pieces.
All right, sir. Okay. Okay.
Yeah, respect.
All right, my brother. Blessings.
Yeah.
Okay. Why this thing has... and people, I'm just saying, no, it's not right. It is not right what we see happening. Under no circumstances at all. And that's what I said categorically. Good morning, caller. How are you?
Morning.
Morning, Dave. How are you?
Good morning. Good.
Yeah.
It's the same thing I was thinking about, where Cruz touched the point, you know. I was listening to Muta last night,
mm-hmm.
Pastor, and I get to understand that Ziggy Marley did a concert.
Mm-hmm.
I raised like 25 million US for give it. Israelis, support the Israeli army. I don't know what truth it is, but Muta is a credible person.
Yeah, okay. But, all right.
But I should be like, I don't really know after Bob Marley, children, them involved in it. Charity work and I have been in it. Thing that we call it.
Foundation. No, man, them have the Bob Marley Foundation in Jamaica, right up at Hope Road, and they have done work. Remember, it was through the Bob Marley in terms of support for the reggae girls and Sidella.
Yeah, I mean, well, right. I heard about she, but...
It's all of them in terms of the foundation and what they do.
What really amazes me, though,
mm-hmm.
is that the Ziggy married to an Israeli.
Is he married to an Israeli girl?
Yeah, I think her father, her grandfather, have some share in some one of those show business. Paramount, something like that, but he married to an Israeli girl.
Okay.
But the question, me asked me, I thought, as a man with a father, set the fight, I would I set an example to really keep certain things in Jamaica, to married to a Jamaican dark skinned girl.
Oh, Bridget.
You can't tell a man.
You can't tell a man who for marry who for love. Come on. Really?
No, I'm saying, but Pastor, it can't be so unpassable that you can't come across a nice, the most nice black.
No, but Dave, come, let's stop now. Are you saying to me, because love is blind, you know? So if you meet somebody and you fall in love, you don't look upon the color of their skin, you look upon the characteristics where you want. Well, even though true, I can't say to you, even though I can't say to you, they found that a lot of cross-racial or cross-ethnic group married it. It comes with problems from the beginning. We have to work with, but still people have overcome that and they may live. I know people who are black and white or black and Indian or whatever have married and them they
but
have lived.
Indian, Indian are black people, Pastor. Indian is black people.
Well, did you know that one of the Issas never married to somebody and it created problems, was put as an outcast. You know that story?
Yes, sir. That's it.
Joey, right.
Married to a China girl and then outcast too.
Yeah, so that's why I'm saying love is love. And I, having moved around, I've visited many places. It work. And we just come up with this thing, say, you must have married to race. Because the human race, everybody come out of out of Africa. Interesting, eh?
Yeah, but Pastor, we know what is amazing, though.
Yes.
Love is blind, but as I said, people character, in fact, I was in love with two white men and they didn't want to marry to me. I mean, I resent them.
You never got married to them. Yeah.
White woman. No, I mean, that's just to my race, man. If I said certain things, I don't follow through.
All right, that's okay.
Me and Cruz have a lot in similarity. You know?
Yeah.
We both love the PNP party, really. It's just that they keep them where I run if I'm really ready. But when I want to shift your pastor, I did have a soldier because I work on a region ship overseas. And the man tell me, say, one of them Russian man, one from Europe, say, if him daughter married to a white man, black man, if I was shooting.
Yeah, that happens. Yeah, that's true.
So, but Pastor, enough of them man in amount to go see a white woman. If you check it out, them are picking with black woman.
Yeah, that's true. That's a reality.
I come back to a cruise, I say, I don't really believe white people are very selfish, Pastor. White people feel that Adam alone won the road. They are very selfish and wicked. But the problem is that, Pastor, in Jamaica, what we should have done, we should have looked out for years and we should have focused on the Israeli thing, regardless of the fact that we never get much support during the apartheid. But it's foolish, it's this boy around and they are not Jews, they are European, that's run away from Hitler. Well, Hitler war was a good war when the Allied tried to stop him, but the people that were killed people in Israel, Pastor, they are European.
Do you know, if you go to Israel now, all right, and let's do a bit of education. If you read the Bible and you see the people who came out of Egypt, it was a mixed multitude. Everybody mixed up. That even now, you have repatriation of Jews from Ethiopia to Israel and from all over the place.
Yeah, that's true.
So if you go to Israel now, this thing that you said that they are blue-eyed, that is not true.
Only for black people now.
The only for black people are Israelis too. What you see on the media, I see that, but there are a lot of people from all over who are Jews and so on. So this thing and the original Jews, it were not people of high skin. They have the Europeans, but they have a mixed multitude of Jews, Ethiopians, all over the place. So I'm...
Pastor, but on a serious note, when I ask you a God there, because you're not an innocent there, but my question is that we are not focusing on the war. We are not looking out. I go to churches and I'm in a bad because my rights were supposed to demonstrate in front of the U.S. embassy because the U.S. I give Israel the strength and the power that side. Them are disregard all of the international law. The same thing when the United States attacked Iraq without the approval of the United Nations and U.S. is an evil country, very evil and they are unfair because Henry Kissinger said, well, it is fatal to be an enemy to the United States.
He said that was that was a Kissinger document, doctrine, as they'd call it, in terms of how it dealt with different people. And we saw that work out in Vietnam, all over the world.
Yeah, all right. Lose along to Vietnam War with a just machine US. US can't do on the fighting, so they won't have technology, they have machine. US lost the Vietnam War with some farmers, rice farmers. Mm-hmm. I think they almost lost the Korean War, so they lost thing that the war where them even cook up with the Afghanistan thing, cause them set up in London with the Russia and them, and them are fight them are Ukraine.
So let me see if I understand it. When they with so Russia went to Afghanistan and they came out, they had to run and leave it. US went there, they had to run and leave it.
Right.
But what I'm saying to you, because remember, you know, the world has gone through different cycles. First, there were the Medo-Persians, the Babylonian Empire. At every time in history, you have different countries that rise up. One time it was the British, Russia, China is coming up now. So at different points in time, different countries become imperialistic in terms of their design.
I'm not sure some parts of the U.S. very one of the worst countries ever. Are we just glorified like that? I'm going to tell you how U.S. further. Mm-hmm. You see them give Jews reparation, and then look out for England to give you reparation to the Queen of
Charles. When you said give Jews reparations, Dave, what do you mean? Dave.
You remember you got some claims that started by Cuba, a letter banner?
Dave, when they say... when they say... U.S. gave Jews reparations. What do you mean?
No, I am saying U.S. has support the fact that the German pressure the German to give the Jews reparations.
I mean, in regards to the Holocaust.
Holocaust, yes.
Right.
All right. You remember when the Cuba them are fly over Cuba? Some people were U.S. cook up from Miami. I let a pamphlet in Cuba and just saw one of them say. Do not fly in a plane from the airspace and solving a problem.
Right.
And Castro shot two of them out of the sky. You know, say so those United States are pressure. Castro to Castro to compensate the data because compensate the family because the planes were never left on a plane. But yet still, them have Israel with all of the mighty power down there. A bomb. The innocent people, I shoot on the people and like that, and them, I support it, and I come up front, I talk on them, say ceasefire. And I tell you, ceasefire for what we want here, what deep dogs, them are pressure in Israel to say, continue, we don't do no massacre and thing, because we run the world, nobody can stop it. But yet still, them are condemn Russia, and them are condemn Iraq, Iran to supply.
All right. But listen to this. Listen to this, because you and people do not understand. There are some people in the world across nations, Chinese, Russia, US thing, they prosper when there are wars happening in the world.
Yes.
It is not about
humanity.
It is not about race, no. It is about money. It is about mammon. That's what it is about. And let us call it what it is. It's about money. More money, getting more money, getting richer. By the way, you are correct.
Them want to stop.
Right. So, and there's not there, and them have another war. But listen to this, Dave. It's now 9:30. The name of Ziggy Marley's wife, her name is Orly Agai, and she's an Israeli of Iranian Jewish descent. Okay? So people, it's kind of interesting, you know. Iran is former Prussia. That's how it go? No. I'll find that out. It's our 9:30 break, so we're gonna go on our break and come back. All right, blessings. Good. Right.
Ready for the war, Jamaica, and the world. You want us back? We are back. The Breakthrough Deliverance Ministry, led by me, the Prophet Mark Stewart, right here on Best 100 FM. This and every Thursday night, from 9 p.m. to 12 midnight. Yes, it's War Room Thursday. Come on out and join us, each and everyone, on Best 100 FM, 100.1, 3, 5, 7, and 9. Come on out.
Come on out.
Join me, the Prophet, Reverend Mark Stewart. And of course, the boss shot, Apostle Marshall. Come for your healing, breakthrough, deliverance, the prayer, the miracle, the word, the testimony, and so much more. Yes, my friends, Best 100 FM, Best 100 FM, War Room Thursday, 9 p.m. to 12 midnight. Join us. We are going to lick it.
Greetings, brothers and sisters. I invite you to join us for the Church of Our Lord Jesus Christ radio program with Elder Kendrick Murray, where we stand firm that Jesus Christ is the Son of God. This broadcast is heard every Saturday from 12 noon to 1 p.m. and again on Sundays from 4 to 5 p.m. The church is located at 3550 Pleasant Valley Road, here in Mobile, Alabama, in the United States. You may visit our website at sonofgodlives.org or our YouTube page at Minister K. Murray. Or you may call us at air code 251-300-8812. God bless you, and we look forward to you tuning in to the program.
Do you need reliable health care?
We have it.
Yes, we do. Great George Street Pharmacy, shop number 897 Great George Street, Savannah, Lamar, Westmoreland. Opening hours, Mondays to Saturdays, 8:30 a.m. to 6 p.m. Call us at 876-603-7372 or WhatsApp us at 876-205-0499. Yes, we have reliable health care for you at Great George Street Pharmacy, Savannah, Lamar.
For a better choice in all your electrical supplies, A, authorized 3M dealer and better brand names, B, better service including free island-wide delivery, C, all major credit and debit cards accepted, it's ABC Electrical Sales, shop number 8, Hagley Park Plaza, Kingston 10, open Monday to Friday, 8 a.m. to 5 p.m., Saturday, 8 a.m. to 4 p.m. We make your electrical jobs as easy as ABC. Call 754-382-5288 or fax 754-3659. ABC Electrical Sales, for a better choice.
Do you need reliable health care?
We have it.
Yes, we do. Great George Street Pharmacy, shop number 897 Great George Street, Savannah, Lamar, Westmoreland. Opening hours, Mondays to Saturdays, 8:30 a.m. to 6 p.m. Call us at 876-603-7372 or WhatsApp us at 876-205-0499. Yes, we have reliable health care for you at Great George Street Pharmacy, Savannah, Lamar.
The following is a paid announcement by the Jamaica Labour Party.
The Jamaica Labour Party is building a healthier Jamaica for us all. This means more doctors, more nurses, more hospital beds, more diagnostic equipment, and more health centers. This means more access to health care for all Jamaicans. It also means shorter waiting times, less medical bills, more smiles, and more lives saved. Join us in building a healthier nation. The Jamaica Labour Party, building for you and your community.
This election day, vote Jamaica Labour Party.
The proceeding was a paid announcement by the Jamaica Labour Party.
The Morning Connection is not your usual talk show. We aim to stimulate discussion and chart new paths to self-empowerment. So please join us, Minette and Percy, on The Morning Connection, Mondays to Thursdays, 6 a.m. to 10 a.m. on Best 100 FM.
Good morning. Welcome back to The Morning Connection. It's now 9:36 on Thursday, the 22nd day of February. Good morning, caller. Thank you for holding. Hello.
very important day.
Yes, it is.
We're talking about human rights.
Yes, sir.
Pastor,
mm-hmm.
Before 1940, have nothing to do with what is going on today.
Crows.
In a country where them call Israel, when they are anonymous. Israel never on the map.
Crows.
Until in the party.
Crows, that is crows. Crows.
Yes.
Crows.
Yes.
All right. You see, because I'm thinking you raised it and I've said to you, you asked me a question, I responded, and I will continue to say we differ on it. All right? So hold on, Cruz. I've never cut you off before, but you continue to persist. I'm saying you asked me, I've told you, I'm saying the history in that region and the history of the world does not begin in 1944. All right?
The history we are dealing today.
No, but I'm saying, okay, Cruz, you said that to me that I do not believe what the Bible says. And I'm saying the Bible is also a historical book. And a lot of what you see happening and being manifested in terms of that region never begun in 1940. Egypt was a place. So I'm just saying to you, talk about something else. We're not going to persist. You ask me about it, and I've told you. Me tell you, I'm not in agreement with people being killed in the way that they're being killed, right? What else you want me to say?
No, but if you go back to before the party, that means you kind of sympathize with Israel.
But how can you make that thing? I'm saying the history before, and to understand what is happening, it is very complex. We have simplified it, and I'm saying to you, I do not cross.
Cross. About what happened today.
And what have I said, Cross? What else you want me to say?
Say Israel wrong. What am I do?
Cross.
I don't know what I'm saying.
Cross.
You know what I'm saying.
Cross.
All right, Pastor. You can come out now.
All right, good. Wonderful. All right.
I don't mind going back to the scripture and believe say Israel people and my God people. I mean, I believe the prophet.
All right, Cruz. So we agree to disagree. No problem.
Yes.
it's kind of interesting. The lines are open.
876-279-8473.
Good morning. Good morning, caller.
Good morning. How are you?
I am very good, sir.
Why, Cruz not the killing at all.
No, but that is Cruz. But so it is, but we have different people in the world and we need to learn to relate to each other and have discourse. He's put something on the table and I say, Cruz, and people believe that some of the things that we see happening, even in Europe, what we see happening with a lot of the conflicts, even in Africa, it never begin today. There are histories. Like in Africa, when the Europeans decided that you're going to make Nigeria this, not taking into consideration the different tribal patterns that were there, and is what causing a lot of the conflicts in some countries.
Indeed.
And people, the people, they don't understand. But anyway, I've said what I've had to say on that issue. It is wrong. You don't indiscriminately kill people on both sides, right? And some of it is evil. It's just pure evil. That's it.
Boy, yeah. I have some friends that stop calling for morning.
Yes.
So them get here early last night.
In regards to the elections?
In regards to the election.
Yeah, what them say now?
Them get here early. Government pay them early.
The government has paid. But the government, people are paid early because, remember, salaries, the pay, they would be paid on the 25th, which is Sunday.
But sometimes most of the time since Jesus, them do it late.
No, they have not doing it because my wife works with government and she don't get paid today or tomorrow. That's what they're going to be doing.
Well, as I said, them get paid from last night.
Well, today, that's how they do it.
Get paid from last night and get paid early.
Yeah, that's good. That's good for them.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. So what's on your mind this morning? Because we've been talking about choices. And my friend who has been in the process, he was just explaining. One of the things I said to people from a point of view is, do not sell your future birthright for a pot a mess, like what something there that Esau did.
Well, them understanding about them go ahead and do it.
All right, well, that's the choice, but you're going to have to live with the choice you're making. You know?
But they don't realize it's a one-day thing, that. When they sell it for one day, what happened after them sell it?
Yeah, well, they'll understand. Those people, like, so some people are saying, we're not going to vote, and I say, it's your franchise. Look at the issues that are there before you and make a decision based on your personal belief and the issues of right and wrong. That's all I'm telling people to do.
You see, them not understand. Say them have the four years to live with that one mistake they make.
Yeah.
When them go and vote, because them get $1,000.
Yeah, it's not $1,000 anymore in Abridging. It gone up. The stakes are higher.
No,
5,000, 10,000. I earn 15. I earn 20, 30,000. All different kind of figures floating around the place.
It's just an example. Them not looking at the future after they met that ex to that person who paid them.
Mm-hmm.
Because at the end of the day is that we the affect. And I think I hear the public sector come out that we're bracing more food tax.
Brave for more what kind of tax?
Food tax.
Okay. Food tax? Taxation
food
on
food? Tax. More taxation on food.
Oh, wow.
They come out and say that we have to brace some more because it is coming.
So who said that? Who said that, my brother? You heard somebody say that, actually?
No, I heard someone say, it was on the news.
Mm-hmm.
It was over the news.
Okay.
It was over the news.
Wow.
So we have to look into all them things there because the prime minister, we're not getting a new tax. What about food tax?
Well,
it is killing we already. So what will happen when we get more tax for food?
I'm a brother. Because most people spend most of their income on food.
Exactly.
And if food goes up, then you don't even have disposable income anymore. Because listen to this. I interact with a lot of people, and somebody told me that they got a job and they're getting paid minimum wage, right? The job that they had for minimum wage, they could easily walk to the location. Then the person says, okay, I'm moving you from Kingston here, you can walk to work over to Portmore. And in one instant, they have to pay $900 per day to go to work. That don't make no sense.
And they guarantee them pay no risk.
Right, the pay has not raised. And I'm saying, how can we do that to persons in this country? Mm-hmm. People are minimum wages, and then you're going to move them from one location and tell them, take it or leave it. That's wicked, man. That's why Bob said man to man is so unjust.
That is exactly what the government do to the public sector, you know. The police, nurse, doctor, everybody, you know.
No, man.
Take it or leave it.
You take it or leave it. And then when people are saying, because on this program, we had the former JTA president, and she was saying, all we want is a livable wage. And she was ostracized. She was threatened.
Yeah,
all
she
different
gets, she
kind
gets
of...
by her own too.
Yeah.
Man who wants to turn to the power.
Yeah, and they did it.
Man who turns to the power, sell her out.
Right. And then
so
she...
go ahead and sign the document. Then.
And she said, in good faith, I cannot sign this. Well, she... head or helter, and then right after, we got a mass exodus of teachers. So when we make decisions, we're not thinking about the implications of what is happening. And if you have an educated population, that is how you increase the general prosperity and abundance of everybody. But if you educate your people to continue to work on the plantation, as it were, my son, who has a first degree, he mustn't leave him. Come on, and say, boy, may I go back to the plantation? May I have to laugh? Because in his own mind, he's working with a big company. He said, boy, it's coming like a plantation in terms of what I'm getting. So, yeah.
We need to sit and look. Those teachers, nurse, doctor, everybody, we sit and look and see that this government here is just a dictator government.
Mm-hmm.
And then sit down with the people and talk to them properly.
Mm-hmm.
And put things the right way.
Well, but that,
just put the point of myself, look here, take it or leave it.
Yeah.
I may give a certain time to take it too.
Yeah, well, that has happened. And it's not, you're not talking things that make up, is what actually happened.
It actually happened.
And even with what has happened with this whole thing with the political obnoxious man and a lot of things, You just take it and run with it. What you do? You can't. What you do?
But we have to make the change, you know, because she said we have to make the change.
Well,
and the change must make.
Well, brother, the choices are the people on. Choice before them. They have to sit, as Joshua said, if the choice is before you, people look at the facts. That's why we did what we did in terms of what you look for in a leader. Think about mind games and information, thinking about what's in your heart. But you ultimately, at the end of it, have to make a choice.
For your own benefit, you have to put the policy aside and make the right choice.
Yeah. All right.
Because at the end of the day, you're going to live with that. So that 5 hours. See, what happened to the local government? Almost 8 years.
Yeah.
We have to live with it.
Yeah. And that's what I'm saying to people. So, at the end of the day, I'm saying you have the choice you have to make. You have to make a choice. Not voting, you're still making a choice.
They don't understand that either.
Yeah. Go out, exercise your franchise.
If you say you want to remove this man and be calling upon you, say you're not going to vote.
Yeah.
The end of the day, if everybody says that, he's going to remain in the same seat.
Yeah.
And there's no one to vote him out.
All right, but that's it. So thank you for calling, my brother. We are at our break, a time to round off the program, but you're the last caller for the day. All right, blessings for you.
And I just said to Jamaican, do the right thing on the 26th, Jamaican. Do the right thing.
Yeah.
Time come.
Yeah, I know where you're going voting, but this is no thing. Ladies and gentlemen, callers who are out there, who are online with us, who have joined me this week, as I have been with you, I just continue to say to you, you have choices you need to make. We're rounding up our program for this week. It's been a good week. We started with the story of Moses and Jethro, his father, who says, when you select people, which was pointing to, even though I'm central, there is a need for local government. And it says, choose capable people, people who fear God, people who are not going to take bribe, people are honest. And then Tuesday we spoke about mind games, that there's a lot of information that comes at you as an individual, but you have to be able to discern, to look to see what is right, what is wrong. The other day we spoke about out of Proverbs 4:23, as a man thinketh in his heart, so is he becoming. And today we speak ultimately about choices, because come Monday, as the Jamaican population, we are going to the local government poll. Some people have said it has turned out to be a national election at the local level. You know, at your local level, what it is that impacts you. You know, you should know by now who are your councillors. People are voting today. Over 40,000 special persons are elected to vote. That's the police. The people are going to be working and so on. They're going to be voting today. So police, military, election day workers are going to be voting today. Some would have voted there because the polls have opened. But I remind you, choice is yours, whether PMP, JLP, or the independents that are there. You have to make a choice. So go out and vote. Go out and vote. You know the issues that are impacting you at the local level. And as Howard Mitchell has said, somebody who has served at the highest level in this nation on different boards, say a man of integrity, he has pointed out some things to us. I say, if we continue on the path that we are in terms of what we see happening locally, nationally, we are moving towards becoming a failed state. This is your host, Percival Palmer. Thanking Jay Pesco for joining us this week. Thanking Mrs. Porter, who joined us to speak about a seminar that is happening on the weekend at Exim Bank, starting from 10 to 4. There's a cost attached to doing it in terms of mastering communications. Saying a big shout out to Minette and the producer who are away on a sabbatical for the time being. They'll return. But this is Percival Palmer signing off for this week. Thursday is our Friday, and coming right after me in this Y-Ways with good music, even as we go into our weekend. Have a lovely weekend. Thank God that we're going to have a violence-free Resta campaign and a violence-free election day. And whatever, whoever wins, remember, God says, I put them there. But you have a role that you can play. Go out and vote. Thank you very much. Signing off from the Morning Connection for today, the 22nd day of February 2024.
I sold I to the merchant ships. Minutes after they took I from the bottomless pit. But my hand was made strong by the hand of the Almighty. We forward in this generation triumphantly. Won't you help to sing these songs of freedom? 'Cause all I ever have, redemption songs, redemption songs. Emancipate yourselves from mental slavery. None but ourselves can free our minds. Have no fear for atomic energy, 'cause none of them can stop the time. How long shall they kill our prophets while we stand aside and look? Ooh, some say it's just a part of it. We've got to fulfill the book. Won't you help to sing these songs of freedom? 'Cause all I ever have, redemption songs, redemption songs, redemption songs. Emancipate yourselves from mental slavery. None but ourselves can free our mind. Oh, have no fear for atomic energy, 'cause none of them can stop at the time. How long shall they kill our prophets while we stand aside and look? Yes, some say it's just a part of it. We've got to fulfill the book. Won't you help to sing these songs of freedom? 'Cause all I ever have, redemption songs. All I ever have, redemption songs. These songs of freedom, songs of freedom.
Forgiven, they want a shelter from the storm. Look In a long line, nobody likes being pushed around. Everybody wants a family protected. They want to express themselves. Everybody wants to live forever. Look at me, I'm into enemy. Don't believe everything you hear. This is no time to fight each other. What we need, what we need. Solidarity.
Best 100 FM, broadcasting live in all 14 parishes. Hanover 100.5, 100.9. St. James 100.9. Trelawney 100.3, 100.9. St. Anne 100.3, 100.5. St. Mary 100.5. West Milan 100.1, 100.5. St. Elizabeth 100.1, 100.5. Manchester 100.1, 100.5. Clarendon 100.1, 100.5, 100.9. St. Catherine 100.5, 100.9. St. Andrew 100.5, 100.9. St. Thomas 100.5 and 100.9. Best FM, giving you the better vibe.
Simply the best. Best FM 100 on your dial. Keep listening.
The following is a paid announcement by the Jamaica Labour Party.
Jamaican people, JLP say building time. Anything less, we not pay them no mind. Building for you and your community. We will build up Jamaica by supporting good policies, yeah. Build a better life for you and for me.
The proceeding was a paid announcement by the Jamaica Labour Party.
No, the water gone again. Yo, Dave, where did you get your water tank from? Multiplastics tanks a lot. Oh, yeah. I heard they're selling cutting-edge water tanks. Let me find my way to 37 South Road or call them at 876-968-6657 now.
Vejam Printers for all your printing needs. We specialize in calendars, flyers, brochures, and more. Call us today at 968-7506. That's 968-7506. Or visit us at 4 East Bloomsbury Road off Hagley Park Road. Vejam Printers, your best choice in printing.
For all your Honda Ridgeline parts in Kingston, call 326-7371 or 821-5232 now. We sell genuine shocks, power steering pumps, engine mount, fender liner, strut mount, front end parts, engine parts, electrical switches and sensors, and many, many more. Remember, we are your Honda Ridgeline parts dealer located in Kingston. Contact us now at 326-7371 or 821-5232 for more details.
Reliable health care?
We have it!
Yes, we do! Great George Street Pharmacy, shop number 897 Great George Street, Savannah Lamar, Westmoreland. Opening hours, Mondays to Saturdays, 8:30 a.m. to 6 p.m. Call us at 876-603-7372 or WhatsApp us at 876-205-0499. Yes, we have reliable health care for you at Great George Street Pharmacy, Savannah Lamar.
February is Reggae Month, and Best FM is catching the rhythm with Roots Kaleidoscope. Every week, we join the Reggae Open University from 6 to 7:30 p.m. Tune in for the latest in music. Meet the icons. Celebrate with us. Catch the rhythm on Best during Roots Kaleidoscope.
Best 100 FM is the authentic voice of Jamaica. Promoting your prosperity with better vibes and better music. Let us promote your goods and services for you. Advertise with us. For more information, call our office at 876-276-8935. That's 276-8935.
It's good. It's better. But nothing beats.
Like a man who walks alone. This perseverance makes a man strong. Looking for a place that I could call home, where I could call God, trust Christ and live life. Like this community is a needed thing. Nobody seems to love truth, they seem to be sheep who love wolves, they love bull. Cause these wolves preach poison and they use fool. And it feels like the valley of death on me, me. I'm running but I'm losing my breath on me, me. Is there any rest for the weary? I tell them, listen, nobody's trying to hear me.
Help me just to love. Teach me to show grace. Gentle in my speech. Patience is what I need. Nothing comes too fast. It only comes with time. Weathered by my life. Patience is what I need.
So alone, I'm getting so impatient. At times I wanna run home.
feel so alone. Good morning, good afternoon, good evening, good night. This is Best 100. I go by the name of Miss Wire Waste.
So here I go.
I'll be here taking you up until the hours of 2 o'clock.
Don't get it when I take them through the scriptures. My mind is moving.
Giving thanks and praise.
That's the truth, man, I'm saying.
Must say many thanks to the Morning Connection. Pastor Percy. Holding the fort.
Begging me to stop it.
And doing it well, mate. Proper.
They looking at me strange.
Massive respect to you.
That was cool with Asian.
Mr. Cruz, beg you, go easy on Percy.
Are you?
Yeah, may I tell you, go easy on him, please.
You change your heart from stony.
He's a wonderful man.
His will, he's sovereign. Just trust the Lord to keep you still.
Help me just to love. Teach me to show grace. Gentle in my speech. Patience is what I need. Nothing comes too fast. It only comes with time. Weathered by my life. Patience is what I need.
Okay, you know how it goes. Like to say a little scripture, do something before we really get started properly. Right, so what we're doing today, it's all about live well. Just live well. So today's scripture is taken from Psalms 90, verse 12. Oh, teach us to live well. Teach us to live wisely and well. Are you living in the house with your family, but you are not connected? Are you engaged, living well, making the most of the moments? Or are you in tomorrow? Open, you will get the contract, worried about your business, wondering how your finances are going to work out. Are you in yesterday, upset over a disappointment, bitter over who hurt you? You are missing the beauty of this day. Once you live this day, you cannot get it back. The people in your life are not always going to be there. Do not wait until they're gone to recognize what you have. Do not take for granted all the good things in your life right now. Get connected. Take time for people God has given you. Okay, so take time for the people that God has given you. All right. There will always be more work, more challenges, and more problems to solve. The dream will come to pass in due season. The problem will resolve in God's timing. Worrying about them does not make them work out any sooner. Stay in the moment with the people you love. Enjoy where you are. Let's do a little prayer. Father, thank you for the beauty that you provide for me every day, especially through my family and all the people I love. Teach me to live wisely and well, and to never allow worry or disappointment to keep me from the present. I declare that I am going to make the most of my moment in Jesus' name. Let's do it.
Ayaka yaga yo, yeah. Words of life I bring to you in my song. It's a blessed thing, so sing along. We don't boost no one, I just try and goodness in every song I sing. In every song I sing, yeah. Side to the blind, hope for the hopeless. If you're shot, time don't wanna see you depressed. If you're hungry, sing nourishment for the belly, biblical real food. Yeah, we're good for the lady, gain some wisdom, man. Now tell me you know what, fulfillment in the life. Now tell me say you can, let love be your guide and overcome. With words of life I bring to you in my song. It's a blessed thing, so sing along. We don't boost no war, I just try and goodness. In every song I sing, yeah. Tell your mother and your father, can they
next of kin. The gift of God is life and the wages of sin is death and destruction. Listen when me sing, me clear like a hurley Sunday morning. Jump up with joy and salute the king. See the living water, take a sip from the spring. Wash away your sufferings, oh yeah. The words of life I bring to you in my song is a blessed thing. So sing along. We don't boost no one. I just die and goodness in every song I sing. In every song I sing, yeah. Arise and shine, now is the time to stimulate your brain and saturate your mind. Word of life, if you seek, you shall find happiness, yes. Man a trendsetter, we different from them. About to peer pressure, no them in a problem. With word of life, we quickly uplift them. Oh, oh. With word of life, I bring to you in my song. It's a blessed thing. So sing, I sing along. We don't boost no one. I just die and goodness in every song I sing. In every song I sing, yeah. Sight to the blind, hope for the hopeless. Deviation time, don't wanna see you depressed. If you're hungry, see nourishment for the belly. Biblical brain food, yeah. We good for the lady, gain some wisdom, man. Now tell me you know what, fulfillment in the life. Now tell me say you can't. Let love be your guide and overcome. Overcome. With words of life I bring to you in my song. It's a blessed thing. So sing along. We don't boost no one. I just try and in every song I sing, in every song I sing, words of life I bring to you in my song. It's a blessed thing. So sing, sing along. We don't boost no one. I just giant goodness in every song.
Thanks and praise can be given in anyhow, any genre of music.
I bring to you.
It's my weekend today. It starts today.
So sing along. We don't boost no one.
Go on.
I just try and goodness in every song I sing. In every song I sing. Yeah.
And I ain't to say run cold am I not. But such that I have given in the name of Jesus arise and warm. Everlasting power.
Blood brothers.
And blood brothers now stop singing.
Power.
Jesus Christ live.
Power.
Achu.
There is power in the name of Jesus. 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 Power in the name of Jesus. Jesus Christ my Lord. There is power in the name of the Most High. One we reach low but yet sit high. Power in the name of the Most High. Oh Jesus Christ my Lord. We sing a Jesus name in it.
And Satan go wide and ball, oh.
A Jesus name in it sound.
The evil spirit them a run out of town, away.
A Jesus name in it preach.
Make people get saved and stop from thief.
Good God in the name of Jesus, mountains will move.
Make and Satan run out of him shoes. The blind shall see when Jesus name use. The deaf shall hear when Jesus name use. The dumb shall talk when Jesus name use. The lame shall walk when Jesus name use.
A natural power is now a court of views. More than conqueror, that's why we can't lose. Lord, I am one where you choose. You hear? Oh, in the name of Jesus. 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 Oh, in the name of Jesus. Jesus Christ, my Lord. There is power in the name of the Most High. One we reach low, but yet sit high. Power in the name of the Most High. Oh, Jesus Christ, my Lord. Now to the one we sit high and reach low.
Good God, trouble on the way, I know.
Oh, Lord, but you save me from the snow. Down the road of destruction, me did a go.
Now there is a brand new road where me know. Oh, Lord, I've been class beyond and go down for me knee. And reach far prior unto thee.
And say, in the name of Jesus, Lord, remember Kennedy.
And in the name of Jesus, Lord, remember unto thee.
Now me road was rough, and it was so rocky. Now me living in darkness, so light me can't see.
But I have comprehend where you showed me.
Oh, in the name of Jesus, Jesus. Christ my Lord, there is power in the name of
seas.
Jordan River of the battles on the Red Sea.
Only by the words of His Majesty.
But on the hill, animals set the captive free.
Only by the words of His Majesty.
He man tremble like leaf and see it and now me flee.
Only by the words of His Majesty.
There is power in the name of Jesus. Jesus, Jesus. Power in the name of Jesus. Oh Jesus Christ, my Lord. We sing power in the name of the Most High. One may reach low, but yet sit high. A Jesus name it call.
Make all Satan go wide and ball. Oh,
a Jesus name it sound.
And even spirit them a run out of town. Go away.
A Jesus name it preach.
Make people get saved and stop from thief.
Good God, in the name of Jesus, mountains will move.
Make all Satan run out of him shoes. The blind shall see when Jesus name use. The deaf shall hear when Jesus name use. The dumb shall talk when Jesus name use. The lame shall walk when Jesus name use.
A natural power in no account of use. More than conqueror, that's why we can't lose. Lord, I am one way you choose. Get that.
Voice of the Judah at Skinder. Yeah, yeah. This one's called Just Spirit, Voice of the Judah Iskender. Just looking at this little paragraph today, okay, and I'm thinking, it's took this long? Is it this long it's taken for them to do this? All right, let me read it. State Minister Juliet Cuthbert Flynn who has been seeking to find ways to address the issue of pregnant women who give birth while in prison. Why do you lot use these big words, incarcerated? Just say while in prison. Has recommended the construction of a fully functioning nursery at the South Camp Correctional Facility. The building, she said, would be completed within the next few months, noting that, in addition, the provision of guidance on proper parenting skill, counselling and needed educational advancement will be a priority. I thought they were doing these things from before. Most of the women, they can go on courses while they're in prison when they're in England. Yeah, all right, they can do all that. I've never been, but I know that's what they do. These provisions, along with others, will seek to ensure better bonding between mother and child, create an atmosphere of hope, and change the mindset and potential negative social of the mothers, okay? No matter what the circumstances, there's always the possibility of molding a better society if we help to change the course of choices. Of course, there will be instances where some mother exceed the initial 6-month period, but provisions would be improved to keep the bonding period consistent. We all know that the best maternal care possible is important for the perfect and harmonious development of a child, and it works wonders for the positive mind of the mothers, Cubitt Flynn said in a statement. I thought they had places like that here long time ago, but you know what, if it's the first, well done. Good on you. I just want to see it though. Not saying it's going to happen. I want to see it happen.
Glory, hallelujah. Hallowed be thy name. Oh, Most High God. Glory be to the Most High God. Hallowed be thy name. King of kings and Lord of lords. Worthy to be praised. I ascribe to you dominion, power and grace. Through all the years and years to come, you'll always be the same. It's me again, Jah, as I fall on my knees today.